into the zone. Timing shot. Save. Rebound. Maddox. Oh,
yes, sir. Point. Polina, her sister, bouncing back down front. And a score.
Oh, yes.
Jackson Cates off the wall. Down low. Underneath. Mo with the save. Rebound. The score. Jackson Cates on the rebound.
Shows up as this is your Pony pregame show brought to you by Stillwater Family Dental. I'm Tom Worchett, voice of the Ponies, and joined by a very special guest here tonight, my broadcast partner for 25 years, Russ Mohaney.
I think we were here 20 years ago, maybe doing a game for Forest Lake or something. It's the last time I've been at this arena. Hasn't changed a bit.
Were we doing a Monomedi game that day?
Yes, we probably were.
Yeah, we had Ben Marshall.
And now their home rink is here too, huh?
Yep.
Okay.
Yep.
All right.
Yeah. But he's Russ Mohaney, and I'm Sam Wunsch, and again, this is our Pony pregame show. Mentioned in the battle for first place here in the Suburban East Conference. The Ponies won the first go-around. You and I watched a little bit of that.
Yes,
and
we did.
Stillwater dominated that one, winning 5-2.
Yeah, and Cretin Derham Hall started out, got a quick goal first in the first period. He got up on the Ponies, but the Ponies came back, and they were just too much for him. You know me, going back to being an old goaltender, I'm going to stand up for these two goalies we got here tonight because who's ever the best is going to come out winning this game. Who's going to out-goaltend and who?
Mike Magnuson for the Raiders and Seth Isley for the Stillwater Ponies. And being the goaltender coach for the Wilderness up there in Cloquet, so you're taking a look at both of them.
Yes, we are. But Isley's pretty much dialed in with we call them the Boston Bruins, but
the Austin Bruins.
Down in Austin, Minnesota, a great junior team and a great program. And Timmy Mattson, the head coach now of the Minnesota Wilderness up in Cloquet, asked me to take a good look and really watch this Magnuson kid. He's something special, but he's going to have to be something special here tonight. We'll see how the cream rises to the crop. A top on a game like this, that's when it's going to have to be.
Well, the Ponies are 19-3. Cretin Derham Hall 16-6-1. Raiders have won 4 in a row. The Ponies have won 3 in a row. So that's our matchup. We're going to visit with head coach Matt Dillman after this first time out. This is Pony Hockey, Suburban East Conference Hockey on Club 1220 KLBB and on VAC Channel 15 here in the Valley. Back in 2 minutes.
Stillwater Boys Hockey is brought to you in part by Lakeview Hospital, Stillwater Medical Group, and the Boys Hockey Boosters and their business supporter, RBC Wealth Management.
Tonight?
Yeah, there's gonna be lots of beer and vodka.
Yeah, I just paid Josh $20 for weed. We're gonna get so high.
Oh, do you think Josh gave us some more alcohol? I wanna get totally wasted.
Yeah, maybe, but my sister has a fake ID. Maybe she could get it for us.
I wish my brother was that cool. My brother only buys me cigarettes.
Well, we better get to class.
Oh. See you at the party.
All right, cool.
And Pony game night continues here from the rec center as we get into Buzz Week. What a schedule the next 5 days. We're going to talk for the few minutes with head coach Matt Dillman before we talk about the opposition. A few weeks ago, you changed things up line combination wise. Took a while to get the chemistry and everything in sync, but if it's the last three games or any indication, 26 goals in three games, we're starting to click again.
Yeah, no question. You know, we know that we have some talented kids, and you know they're seniors. So you know, I think at this time of year, that pressure and that sense of urgency is going to do one of two things for you. It's either going to crush you or it's going to make you rise up. And I really do think like these guys are taking it personal. You know, each time they step on the ice, that they want to do anything they can for the team. And like you said, I think they took a little bit of an adjustment, but really not so much that as you know, we've just started playing better. We've started doing some really good things. So really everybody's benefited from that. And that's what we try to preach as well. It's what's good for one of us can be good for all of us. And I think we've seen that over the last few games.
And that Lakeville North game, I don't know what you took out of that. We had some lapses in our defensive zone. Did you change anything up after that North game?
You know, we watched the film and, you know, we showed some of the good, some of the bad, and you know you try to learn from both. Whether you know at the end of the, if you lose or you win, you're not playing a perfect game. So there's always some things that you do try to take out of it. And you know playing a team like that, that's a great film session because they're a good team. You're going to have to beat teams like that. You're going to have to figure out, you know, those little things really do make a big difference in a tight game like that against another really good team.
All right, first game of three here this week. Suburban East Conference title on the line, Cretin Derham Hall, and talk about Jimmy O'Neill's club.
It's going to be a tough matchup. Obviously the success they've had this year in conference and in non-conference, they got some aggressive, fast, skilled forwards. They're obviously well coached. Jimmy and those guys do a great job over there every year. We're really just kind of focused on making sure we do the things that we can do, and starts by playing really good defensively, making sure we're on top of guys and attacking down. And if we do that, I feel like we're a pretty tough team to handle.
All right, and hopefully we can jump from that. And White Bear Lake speaks for herself.
It's always a battle, you know, and you know really no different from you know Cretin with us in the last few years. It's a tough playoff. I mean, 2 years ago we played in the first game of the year and it felt like a playoff game. You know how physical and you know how fast it was. So it's always a battle with these guys, and especially if you got one of our banners are on the line, there's a little bit something extra that will go into it, hopefully.
And you know Holy Family's laying in wait after what happened last year.
Yeah, that's, you know, you come right back with those guys to finish up your third game, a big, physical, strong, aggressive team coming at you. So, you know, really, we kind of did it on purpose, try to get some tough games coming down the end. Wasn't necessarily trying to get three in a week, but, you know, that's how it goes. But, banners on the line, coming into playoff time, you know, we want to be trying to, you know, be clicking on all cylinders here.
Well, if this week doesn't get us ready for sections, nothing will.
That's right.
And that is head coach Matt Dillman. That is the coaches section of our Pony pregame show brought to you by Stillwater Family Dental. And we'll take a final break. We'll be back. Bob will have the introductions. We'll have much more from the Blizzard Rink after this time out here on VAC Channel 15 and on Club 1220. KLBB back in 2 minutes.
Stillwater Girls Hockey is brought to you in part by Lakeview Hospital Stillwater Medical Group, and the Girls Hockey Boosters and their business supporters, Twin Cities Orthopedics, Kazi's Tavern and Grill, Liftbridge, and Sletton and Breton Orthodontics.
Welcome to Sletton and Breton Orthodontics. We're a third-generation, family-owned orthodontist with locations in Stillwater and Hudson. Our mission is to provide world-class smiles with unique offerings of braces and aligner therapy. Dr. Sletton uses clear brackets coated with adhesive that protect enamel from decalcification. Sletton and Breton, where we treat you like family.
His wingers are number 15, senior John Gleason, and number 21, junior Joe Buckingham. And the remainder of the Cretin Derham Hall Raiders head coaches Charlie Basco, Jim O'Neill, assistants Chris Hickey and Chris Wyatt. Now the starting lineup for the Stillwater Ponies. In goal, number 31, senior Seth Heisley. His defense, number 3, senior Jesse Bukestead. And number 16, senior Jack Mapstall. The forwards are number 9, senior Matthew Stanton. Number 11, senior Noah Cates. Number 13, senior Austin Murr. And the remainder of the Stillwater Ponies, head coach Matt Dolman, assistant coaches Pete Hamilton, Scott Newstead, Paul Benson, Rick Thomas, and Phil Fox. Ladies and gentlemen, please rise. Gentlemen, remove your hats as we honor our country with the national anthem.
Our national anthem as we get set for Suburban East Camp and Shackey. This broadcast also made possible Russ Bohatti's appearance, made possible our good friend Ron Vanelli. Vanelli's out the lake.
Oh, what a great place to eat, Tom. Head on up there. Ron wanted me to mention Wednesday night, all the crab you can eat on Wednesday nights, and Friday, Saturday, prime rib specials and a whole lot more at
great
Vanelli's.
Place to eat up there.
Vanelli's
the
by the lake, downtown Forest Lake.
Mike Magnuson will be in goal for Jimmy O'Neill and Shelly Masco. Mike with a 14-6 record, 2.63 goals against average, save percentage of 90.5. And Seth Lively, big Seth in the goal for the Ponies. 17-3 his record, a sterling 1.34 goals against average, and a save percentage of 92.6. And the junior varsity game went by way of the Ponies. That's their 22nd win of the year, 22-1 for Paul Benson and the crew. They defeated the Raiders by a score of 8-0.
Yeah, talking to Coach O'Neill, almost all these Raiders will be back next year, except for the goalie. Magnuson and Manny are going to graduate, but they're going to be looking for a goaltender next year. And the two that played in that JV game look a little shaky. Here we go.
Off the face of Jesse Bukestead, back into his own zone, paired with Jack Mapstone, Austin Murr, Noah Cates, and Matt standing up front. Puck inside. The Stillwaters run up along the near side boards. Murr gets it out to center ice. Knocked down there by William Pope. The junior will send it into the Stillwater zone. Bukestead back behind his zone. And we have an offside call.
Evidently against Cretin Derham Hall.
Raiders offside. They're wearing the purple and gold. Ponies wearing the red, white, and gray. And immediately Coach D will change up his lines. Coming out is Michael Coffin, Luke Manning, and TJ Sagasur. And it remains Matt Gleason. He's the freshman. John Gleason, the captain. He's the senior. And John Buckingham is the junior. As off the face-off, puck hits center ice and into the offensive zone. Walked in. There's Buckingham out front and cleared away from in front of the net by the Ponies. and played up along the near side board for Sagasaur. TJ gets it out to center ice, but back checking to take it away. Johnny Gleason, he'll dump it back down inside the pony zone. And now the Raiders are changing on the fly and the puck at center ice. And the line out there now for the Raiders is Nicholas Castro Jr., Nick Davidson, a freshman, and Joseph Gibberlin, and he is a junior. But there's a goal right out front. Is that reading off my chart? Looks like Luke Manning. Boy, getting the goal for the Ponies, 58 seconds into the second game. It's 1-0 in favor of the Stillwater Ponies.
And that's the first time Stillwater had the puck in Cretin Derham Hall's zone. It went down behind the goaltender Magnuson, and a pass came from behind the net out in front. Guy just shot it, went right between his five hole in his legs and into the net. It wasn't those slow creepers that should be stopped with your stick. And if the puck gets away from your stick, it squeezes through those pads and in, and the Ponies are up 1-0.
Number 25.
They gave it to Kaufman.
Michael Kaufman with the assist to number 19, Luke Manning, and number 22, TJ Sagasaur. Time of the Pony goal, 58 seconds of the first period.
All right, thank you, Bob. And so Michael Kaufman gets his 10th of the year, 58 seconds into the hockey game. TJ Sagasaur and Luke Manning, his partners on that blue line. Our correction on that line, it is 1-0. Pulling standard into the offensive zone, into the slot, tipped right out front. Magnuson is down, and it's swept away by John Gleason. Coming back, 3-on-2, back the other way, left the wing, and into the offensive zone. And I believe the Raiders, again, were offside at the blue line.
In the defense of goaltenders, Tom, the hardest save of the game is the first one, because you're so nervous. That's no excuse, but it is. I mean, these guys deal with a lot of butterflies, and it looked like Magnuson just wasn't ready for that at all.
So 1-0, Ponies face up just outside that Stillwater blue line, controlled by the Ponies, set up ice. Back into his own zone is William Pope, up along the near right wing boards, turned back by Stillwater into the offensive zone, standard down the left wing, and it's broken up on the defense by Matt Gleason. Puck in the near corner in the Raiders zone, up along the near side boards, comes to center ice and headman pass. Here comes Gleason into the offensive zone. That's Johnny Gleason. Gleason with a shot on goal. Seth Heisley with his first save of the hockey game. Mentioned Johnny, he's the captain.
Now he's a senior, yep, and his brother is a freshman, and he's the highest scorer on the team. He's got 20 goals, more than anybody else on this Raider team.
One other double figure, that Joseph Gimberlin, number 13. And of course, for the Ponies, Matthew Stanton has 21. Michael Kaufman now with 10. Noah Keynes with 18. Luke Manning with 15. TJ with 18 goals on the season. Off the faceoff, there's a shot that's deflected out front, and it's popped high in the air and against that back wall inside the Stillwater zone. As they played 2 minutes of this first period in this battle for the SEC championship, and out of the corner, in that far corner inside the Stillwater zone, holding the offensive zone is Tucker Cruz. He's a senior with Edward Virtus, a senior, and Jack English, a senior, and one of the alternate captains for Coach Jimmy O'Neill and Shotty Bascom. Against that far side board, there's Adam Isley out there. Adam Isley out there with Parker Detke and Mason Bartok at third line. And from neutral, it'll Bukes that it's driving into the Raiders zone. Buck against the near side boards at the half wall, and it's Detke to play it down low. And picked up there by Mason Bartosz. Bartosz has a poke checked away by the Raiders. Mason from center ice will backhand it in to the CDH zone. And deflected off the stick of Magnuson. Daniel after the puck. There's Adam Isley on the intercept. Adam out front at the half wall. Drops low in the corner. The Ponies are changing. Coming out is Manning, Kaufman, and Sagasaur. Four-man tap in the near corner inside the Raiders zone. And dug free by Parker Detke. Manning taking hard in that wall, but manages to hold onto the puck. Feeds the point for Joey Nobilini. He's out there with Parker Wiley, our defensive pair. Manning top of the circle, down the wing. Drop pass, Kaufman goes up top, slot shot. Saved by Magnuson. Or did it go in?
No, it went in.
It went in.
He's back in the net too far. The puck was shot from the almost 10 feet, maybe inside the blue line. I don't know, these goalies play in way too far as I'm concerned. Anytime that puck goes out to the point, you gotta be on top of that crease at least. And that time he was back too far. Great shot by the Pony shooter there and put it right to his left, right over his glove hand and into the net and make the score 2-0.
TJ Sagasaur, his 9th of the year at 3:16. And Luke Manning will get another assist down that goal and a second assist from Michael Kaufman. So those three combined on goals one and two.
number 22, TJ Sagasaur, with the assist to 25, Michael Kaufman, and number 19, Luke Manning. Time of that goal, 3 minutes, 19 seconds.
And Austin Murray with a shot at goal, and the right pass saved by Magnuson. Back at it, center ice. Johnny into the offensive zone. Gleason, drop pass for his brother, Matt. He puts the shot wide off into the near corner. So 2-0 Ponies, and 3 minutes and change just gone here in the first period. Matt said it, fire corner in zone in, right to left. And he'll flip it out to center ice, bouncing puck. And it's loose into the Raiders zone. There's Austin Murray in on the forecheck. And going back forward is Billy Hanza, junior defenseman, paired with Michael Murphy for the Raiders. Ponies aggressive forecheck, two-man forecheck. They hold the offensive zone down in the corner. Here's Noah Cates. Cates for standing, spun around and taken away by Matt Gleason. And he drops it off for the defense and picked up by Michael Murphy. Murphy, his pass is broken up. Good forechecking job there by the Ponies. And there's Brody Swanson out there. Brody, it's just his second game back after a season-long knee injury.
Boy, Stillwater doing a great job in putting on that heavy forecheck, Tom. Dropping three men down, just bottling up the Raiders in their zone.
And there's Brody Swanson back end of the offensive zone. Late offside, and now it neutralizes the Ponies. They feed Bukestad into the zone. Jesse goes wing down the slot. In on goal. Marchand shot, and it may have hit the pipe. A correction, Adam Isley, 32, not 37. Boy. Brody Swanson in that far corner. The Ponies hit 5 shots, 10-1 for the Raiders. And at the line, Bukestad tries to hold it in. It'll be an offside. It came out. Jesse dumped it back in, caught a couple of his teammates offside at the line. 5-1 again, the shot, Shen Gold, 2-0 Ponies.
And the Ponies are buzzing in that offensive zone, just controlling that puck. The Raiders can't get a hold of it. And when they do, they have turnovers. They've had two serious turnovers that the Ponies have capitalized on.
Now the Ponies now have 28 goals in the last 9-plus periods as they hold the offensive zone once again. Out of the corner, Luke Manning goes up top in the slot. TJ snapshot, save by Magnuson. And the rebound up in the near corner from the point. There's a shot taken by Joey Riley. And Joey back at the point. Joey played forward here the other night against Woodbury. Got his first goal of the year. But a roll out, Joey Riley paired with Parker Wiley back there in the blue line. And now the change line. Here comes the Cates line with Stanton. And Austin Murr out for the Ponies. Face off to the right of Magnuson. And they draw one by the Ponies. Taken away by CDH and sent out to center ice. And back into the zone, and Stanton feeds the wing far side for Murr. Murr to Stanton on the drop pass off the end of his stick. Picked up and cleared and out to center ice. As Castro coming back, Nicholas Castro sends it into the Stillwater zone. 11:16 to go in a 2-0 first period. Wild Apple on the right wing board, touch pass, and played out to center ice. Noah Cates on the wing for Stanton. Back to Noah, pass never got there. And the Raiders broke it up for the back check, taken away by Gimberlin. Joseph to center ice, Gimberlin into the Pony zone, high slot. Trying to drag it through. Turns and fires against the near side boards. Broken up by the Ponies against the near side wall. Flipped to the line. And it's held in by William Pate. Four-man tie-up at the Pony blue line. Raiders hold it in. Going back for it is Wiley. He'll go reverse far side. On that wing of Stanton. Clears that out of the zone. Nope, he cleared it up into the bench on a deflection inside the Stillwater Pony bench. Mentioned the JV one. And congratulations, Lucas Monson, 3 goals. Jack Reinseth, 2 goals. Matthew McGinley, 2 goals. Joey Petty with 1 goal. Jesse Brown, the shutout. The Stillwater JV, 22-1 on the season.
Yeah, well, they got a lot of depth in this town, and they got a lot of hockey players. And that JV's really good.
And the Bantam team, number 2 in the state behind White Bear Lake.
There you go.
And the Ponies coming out right to left down the breakout pass and out the center. Here comes Kaufman into the zone. Fires, and there's a waffle pass save by Magnuson back behind. Then that's Kaufman again. And off the end of his stick, he's taken hard into the boards. Far side, Manning is there as well. Tagasaur gets the puck. TJ up top for Bukestad. Jesse snaps one off. Love save by Michael Magnuson. He'll hold on as the Ponies get their 9th shot on goal of this hockey game.
Yeah, and we're not even halfway through the first period. So Magnuson is getting, but he's starting to get more focus. That time, Tom, he was out on top of the crease when Jesse took that shot from the point. The goalie saw it all the way coming in, grabbed it with his glove and froze it. Face off to the Raiders right.
And Logan Hubert, excuse me.
Hang on, Witchy,
on. It's my third game this week.
Yeah.
All right. puck. And Brody Swanson tried to bring it into the zone. Logan Huber is on this line, by the way, for the Ponies, coming off that JV, sophomore.
Yeah, he just took a nice shot. It was about at the top of the circle, so Magnuson had plenty of ways to see that. He saw the puck completely, and that's what's so important to the goaltender, to see the puck. Just focus and watch that puck. Do not lose sight of it. And that's what happens to so many of them. They just lose sight of it, and they're not focused.
So Mason Bartosz out there playing with his third different set of wingers. Puck to the line, Mapstone to hold it in. Down the boards and played by Logan Huber. His pass is broken up, but there is Bartosz, puts it back behind the Raider net and off it in the near corner. Up along the near side boards and out to center ice. And off the skate there, Buckingham. And from neutral ice, Bartosz takes care of his man. Mason, the puck, taken away. Back into the zone, here comes Buckingham. Johnny Stapp put off and it's way wide. And up along the near side board, jumping into the play is William Pope to hold the zone. There's a centering pass out front, and is tipped by Buckingham up over the glass. And that one is out of play, 9:19 to go in a 2-0 first period.
He was open on the right side in the back door on Isley there, and Seth never saw him there. They tried to get the puck to him. By the time it got to him, he just kind of whacked at it and went, missed the net completely, so not even a shot on goal for the Raiders.
All right, Richie tried to hang in here. I've only done about 50 hockey games this winter. Off the faceoff, into the offense of the Stillwater zone, cleared by Stannard on the back end of the line, and out to center ice. Hanza, his pass and picked off. Here come the Ponies. Joey Raleigh into the zone. Kate shot just wide. Oh, he's got a good wrist.
He sure does. That got away from Magnuson's glove, too.
There's Noah Case against the back wall. Out front, Murr with a shot into the pads of Magnuson as he covers up on that far pipe to hold on and get a whistle and a Staffridge of play.
Boy, did Cates let that shot go. He was about 10 feet in front of that goaltender, and it was just a bullet of a wrist shot. But your big goal scorers can shoot the puck.
Off the faceoff, hit traffic out front, and from the line is poked free to center ice, and coming back one on two into the zone is Gimberlin. Gimberlin got spun around on a check there by Joe Raleigh. Puck back behind the Stillwater net. And it's popped free by Castro. Nicholas Castro in that far corner goes up to the point. Michael Murphy with a shot, hits bodies. Murphy again with a shot and sticked away by Seth Isley. Puck back behind the Stillwater net. And there's no Mulaney to feed the right wing for Austin Murr. Murr out of the zone and out to neutral ice. Raiders get outside. They'll dump it right back into the Pony zone. Boy, that Nicholas Castro, he's a big guy. Puck to the line, tipped out to center ice by Austin Murr. Flip back into the offensive zone by Billy Hanza. Nobelani going back for Stillwater. Drop pass in the corner for Stannard. Coming up that far right wing. Stannard to his back end. And coming out his off wing, Big Mayat. Coming to center ice, their wide receiver out the football team. Into the zone, down the wing. And tried to pull it to the forehand, went off the end of his stick.
Looked like a Bobby Orr move all the way from end to end.
And a shot from the point by Wally. That is blocked by Magnuson. Puck against the near side boards. And into Stannard, down to the corner for Manning. Manning back behind the Raider net. On the weak side for Wally. Parker off the end of his stick. He'll play it down low along the dasher board. There's TJ. Sagan's throw for Manning as they play catch back behind the cage. Manning gets a pick up the boards. Bjergstedt shot. Scores! Jesse Bjergstedt from the point. Never got an inch off the ice.
That might have been tipped though, Tom.
Yep. We'll have to wait and see. Yeah, the time of the goal will be 9:28. Bjergstedt will definitely get an assist on the goal.
Well, he let it go from the point, but it was on the ice.
Right.
It never got off the ice. It slid on the ice, and it was coming hard at the goaltender. It looked like somebody's stick was on the ice right in front of the goaltender and misdirected it right into the net.
And we'll get the scoring from Mr. Bielenberg in just a bit.
Number 22, TJ Sagasaur, with the assist to number 3, Jesse Bjergstedt, and number 19, Luke Manning.
Time of that. And so, TJ, his second of the game, his 20th of the year, and Manning will get his third assist of the year. Jesse Bjergstedt, who took the initial shot, he'll pick up the assist, and the Ponies lead by a score of 3-0, dominating this first period, outshooting the Raiders 13-3.
What they're really doing is dominating the puck and controlling the puck in their offensive zone constantly. Cretin can't do nothing down there.
And the Raiders win that faceoff, and then forechecking is Manning to break it up. Comes to center ice, and on the move is Buckingham into the Pony zone, and it's broken up and comes out to neutral ice. And we have a whistle and offside.
Yep.
Yep, the lead offside called against CDH. Faceoff will come outside the Pony zone. Ponies and White Bear Lake. That's one of our three losses. Bears beat us. You and I had a chance to do
right.
that game, 2-1.
But that was all Bob Pirano, the goaltender for White Bear Lake, Bob Pirano. He's hot. He was hot. And you run into, that's what's happened to Stillwater in their losses. They run into some hot goaltenders, and when you're hot, no matter what you do. And he did it against them in that 2-1 loss.
Do you know where Pirano might be going?
No. I talked with him after that game. He had no idea. He wanted to know about the tryouts for the Wilderness, too.
Okay.
And I gave him a card and have him call me or Timmy Matson after the end of the season.
Ponies into the offensive zone, 2-on-1. Down the wing, shot hits the side of the goal. On a shot by Austin Murr, puts it out front. And the Raiders clear it off the boards and out the center ice. Turned back by the defense. And back inside the Raiders zone. Dutko in on the forecheck. Walked out of the end by Matt Gleason. Dropped it into another gear. Round one, round two. And then the puck off the end of his stick. Boy, he's a good one. Matt Gleason puts it out front. And out front again, Gleason. And finally, poked over, checked away from him. Michael Murphy will drive it right back into the offensive zone. Eyes will leave it there. Breakout pass. Dutko at center ice. Parker one on two into the zone. Tripped up and goes down. There's going to be a penalty. Ponies will go on the power play as soon as the Raiders touch the puck. And the time of the penalty will be 11:08 this first period. Ponies in the power play. And boy, have the special teams been good over the last few games. Stillwater now has 25 power play goals on the season. They have 10 shorthanded goals on the season. Special teams accounting for 35 goals. And here comes the power play unit. That's Sagasord, Cates, and Manning. Stannon and Bukestead. That's the number one unit. Off the faceoff, directed towards the goal. Cates back behind that, taken away from him. Ran out front, step attempt by Sagasord, looking for the hat trick. Bukestead scores! Jesse Bukestead picking up the power play goal, number 26 on the season. And Jesse Bukestead has his fifth power play goal of the season, number 26 for the Ponies.
Well, that was Noah Cates going down there, getting the puck behind the Raider net. And again, they're winning all the battles in the Cretin Derham Hall zone and keeping control of that puck, even though they had a man advantage. Didn't take them long to score again. I thought Magnuson was back in the net again, way too far on that shot. It was taken from the top of the faceoff circle to his left.
Here's Bob.
On a power play, number three, Jesse Bukestead, unassisted.
And they're going to give Jesse the unassisted goal at 11:16. Again, his fifth power play goal, 10th of the season, 26th power play goal for the Ponies. They lead 4-0, still 5:21 to go here in the first period as a save by Big Seth back at the other end.
Well, I'm sure.
I didn't anticipate something like this.
No, I didn't either. But, you know, after watching that first game, you know, Stillwater pretty well controlled Cretin Derham Hall in that first game. 5-2 would end up a score at Highland Arena, Cretin Derham Hall's arena, but still, I thought the Ponies literally dominated that game. Not as much as this game so far.
Raiders send it in the offensive zone, clear the line, and poke free to center ice up the near side boards. Into the zone is Coffin. Coffin into the slot. Drop pass, poke checked away. Coming back, the Raiders send out the center ice, taken by Nick Davidson, another freshman for this young Raider team. What do you say, they've got eight seniors?
Eight seniors, and they got two freshmen that play almost every other shift.
There's Jack Mapstone from center ice. Jack, our senior defenseman, off the end of his stick as the Raiders regroup back in their own zone. As Pope and Magnuson playing catch up the right wing and into the offensive zone comes William Pape, drives it into that far opposite corner. First man into the forecheck is Nolan Kanzemius. He's just a sophomore. Grayson Melosh, not spelled like Jilly. Grayson Melosh, a sophomore, and Michael Kramer, Jr. out there for the Raiders. Buck out at center ice and coming back. There comes Melosh into the offensive zone. Shot, pad save by Isley. Deep rebound on the far side boards. Poke free by Logan Huber out to center ice and driven right back in. The Ponies with a third line that keeps changing wingers. And Swanson out there, Huber out there, and Mason Martash out there. And the puck up along the near side boards. I think we're going to see some other players too off that JV before this game is comes to a close. Kramer sends it into the Stillwater zone, and he takes Novellini into that back wall. Puck up along the near side boards. Played, picked off down that wing. Gleason, Matt, shot. And shoot away by Isley. Puck in the near corner. Martash for Brody Swanson to the half wall. Brody stood up on a check, comes to the point. There's a blast. Isley with a stick save as Nick Oren took the shot, a senior defenseman. And from neutralized, Ponies sent it into the Cretin Derham Hall zone. 3:30 to go. And what do we have? We have a penalty behind it now.
Looks like it.
And immediate Buckingham got to the scorer's table before the referee did. Or maybe it is not on, Johnny. And it looks like Matt Gleason is going to sit for a couple minutes, the young freshman.
Well,
and the Ponies will be on yet another power point.
When your big-time players are freshmen and sophomores, this is what they run into when they run against big-time players that are seniors. You know, just so far, Stillwater has completely dominated this game in all phases, from face-offs to control in the corner to control in the offensive zone, the breakups in the neutral zone, and that's why the shots are 15-5 in favor of the Ponies.
And Melosh and Manning on the draw. Raiders win that face-off. And the puck back behind them. There's TJ off in the corner for Manning. Manning sets up at the half wall. And he walks in, goes down low for Sagaso in the corner. TJ goes up top slot. Bukestead on the weak side. Wing for Matsen. He backs up. Jesse gets a hold of it. And he blasts. And it's just wide. Manning with a rebound against that far side board. Down low for Noah Cates. Out front. Scoring is Matsen. What a pretty three-way passing play. Manning to Cates. To Stannett. And Matsen has yet another power play goal for the Ponies. And their second of the game. Number 27 on the season. Matsen with the goal at 13:58.
Well, if there ever was a beautiful play in the power play, the clinic was right there and how to do it by Stillwater. What a play. Bukestead, of course, starting it off from the point. Again, I felt Magnuson is back too far in the net. If he stand out and top that crease, Bukestead wouldn't have near the room to get it in the net, but they just did that picture perfect.
With the assist to number 11, Noah Cates, and number 19, Luke Manning.
Well, Luke Manning doing the job. Four assists for Luke. Noah Cates for this first point. He had five assists the other night against Woodbury. Matt Stannett has his 26th goal of the year. There's another goal as I look up. And Austin Murr to put it in. Austin Murr scrambled in front of the net. And Austin Murr makes it a 6-0 contest.
I think Jimmy better take a timeout.
14-23.
Our goalie's beat up, and Manny, who's the second-string goalie, Manny Hurdle Bauman, he hasn't played a game all year. It's been all Magnuson. And right now, Mike has got a red neck. If there was a red light behind the cage, it would start to be getting sunburned. His neck would.
Murr with his 11th goal of the year at 14-23. It is 6-0 in favor of the Ponies. Six goals on 18 shots. That's pretty productive. Here we go.
Number 13, Austin Murr, with the assist to number 11, Noah Cates, and number 9, Matthew Stanton. Time of that goal for the Ponies, 14 minutes, 23
seconds. All right, there it is. Austin Murr, his 11th. Cates and Stanton on the assist. And we still have 2:13 to go in this first period. Puck against the near side boards in the Stillwater zone. Clear the line and all the way down inside the Raiders zone. And it crawls over the goal line, and that'll be an icing call.
Well, you know, this is what concerns me and why I work with kids still in my old age, because I believe in our kids of America. But we have a tendency of once it starts to rain, it pours and the guys can't regroup. Granted, the momentum changes, but Cretin is just going digging themselves deeper in a hole here all the time.
And from center ice, flipped into the Raiders zone, Manning after the puck, and he'll get to it first. And he leaves it for TJ Sagasore. Puts it in the slot, never got to Michael Kaufman. And we've got a penalty to be handed out. We have an elbowing call to come at the 15-13 mark. And the Raiders, who have already given up two power play goals, and sitting for a couple minutes will be Liam Ryan, junior defenseman.
That doesn't help either. And then you get chippy and you get frustrated. You start taking stupid penalties like that one.
Matty Hertel Bauman is their backup goaltender.
Yeah, and he hasn't played at all hardly this year, Jimmy told me before the game.
Stannett from the point, near point, goes up top in the slot. They go 1-3-1. And here's Stannett on the weak side. Fire is saved by Magnuson. And the puck off into the near corner. Taken away by Sagasor. He's got two. Cates out front on the weak side for Matt Stannett right through his legs. He backs up to the point. Feeds Bukestead in that high slot. On the wing for Cates. Down low for Manning. Manning up top again for Jesse. Here's the blast, wide. And the rebound back behind the net. Manning, again, Jesse walks in, fires, and that's a rising shot up over the net as it is just tail gunner time.
20 shots, we're going on 20 shots here for the Ponies.
And out of the corner out front, CJ scores! That's his hat trick! TJ Sagasaur, he has the hat trick in the first period. He made it 2-0, made it 3-0, he makes it 7-0 at 15-58.
Well, that time was just a picture-perfect play, but the Cretins just standing around their own end, doing nothing, and the Ponies are just moving the puck at will right now, Tom.
And there'll be a couple assists on that goal. And for TJ, that's his 21st goal there. The hat trick in this period. Luke Munson had a hat trick in the JV game. And off the faceoff, the puck comes out to center ice. Here's Bob.
Number 22, TJ Sagasaur, with the assist to Luke Manning. And number 17, Brody Swanson.
7 goals, have they done that at all this year? 7 goals in the first period against anybody?
They've had a 5-goal period, but not a 7-goal
wow.
period.
First period, and that's another Kate's fine home power.
And 48 seconds to go here in the period.
Where are all the hats on the ice, Tom? I mean, don't these people in Stillwater throw out their hats for a hat trick?
Evidently not. They don't realize
that. I didn't see one hat out there for TJ.
Austin Murr into the zone. Drop pass slot. Kaufman over skates and taken away by the Raiders. And back they come up the left wing. And it's dumped into the offensive zone by Michael Kramer. And it's tied up against Noah. Maybe clear the ice surface. And that one is out of play.
Yeah, who'd have expected this?
Well, I was thinking somebody predicted a 4-3 overtime game.
We got an interference penalty against number 13. No.
Austin Murr, 2 minutes at 16:32. And Stillwater will go on the power, or correction, yeah, it'll be Cretin Derham Hall on the power play. They've got 16 power play goals, one short and a goal. But Pony special team, 3 power play goals tonight, 28 on the season. And they have 10 shorthanded goals. The puck out of center ice. Raiders have to get onside. Played up the right wing board by Daniel Magnuson. Cleared right back out again. And played up the wall. Nick Davidson claims one of those points. Poke free at the blue line. And the Raiders trying to get onside. They do into the zone. And there's another poke check to break it up. And as the buzzer sounds, Austin Murr, or correction, Noah Cathwaite had himself a shorthanded opportunity. We've played 17 minutes of textbook hockey by way of the Stillwater Ponies. They put on the clinic here in the first period, Russ.
They certainly did, Tom. And you wonder why they've been rated number one in the state most of the year. Well, that's the reason why, boy. When they turn on all these jets in this team, they fire it, they control it, they have everything going for them. Cretin had nothing for them in that first period. I'm sure Jimmy O'Neill's going to really have to put his team together here between periods and figure out a way. The least win faceoffs, the little things, you know? Work on the little things. Starts with a faceoff and goes from there to controlling the puck, to moving the puck out of our own end. Look at the shots, they're 20-5. 20 shots in one period. Well, the goalie's got to be shell-shocked. I'd be walking around like this, Tom. Punch drunk. I mean, you know, that's what happens. But somehow you got to try to change it and get back in this game, and it's not easy.
This is our first intermission. We'll step away, come back, and recap a busy period of scoring. We'll do that in 2 minutes. As this is Suburban East Conference Hockey on Club 1220 KLBB on VAC Channel 15 here in the Valley. Back in 2 minutes.
Stillwater Boys Hockey is brought to you in part by Lakeview Hospital, Stillwater Medical Group, and the Boys Hockey Boosters and their business supporter, RBC Wealth Management.
Party tonight?
Yeah, there's going to be lots of beer and vodka.
Yeah, I just paid Josh $20 for weed. We're going to get so high.
Oh, do you think Josh gave us some more alcohol? I want to get totally wasted.
Yeah, maybe, but my sister has a fake ID. Maybe she could get it for us.
I wish my brother was that cool. My brother only buys me cigarettes.
Well, we better get to class.
Oh. See you at the party.
All right, cool.
Thank you, JP. You and Richie sharing company. Russ Mulhaney riding shotgun here tonight on a special occasion. Jordan Simpkins is our director tonight. Frosty's on camera. And nice to have you along. How about this first period? 58 seconds into this hockey game. It was Michael Kaufman picking up his 10th goal of the year from Luke Manning and TJ Sagasore. The Ponies made it 2-0 at the 3:16 mark. TJ Sagasore got his goal with Manning and Kaufman on the assist. And then it was TJ making it 3-0, his 20th goal of the year, with Jesse Bjungstad and Luke Manning another assist. And the Ponies had a 3-0 lead. Ponies in the power play, they make it 4-0 at the 11:16 mark. And Jesse Bjungstad gets his 5th power play goal and his 10th overall goal, 27th power play goal for the Ponies. And that was a non-assisted goal. The 5-0 goal belonged to Matt Stannon. And Cates and Manning on the assist. And for Matt Stannon, his 26th goal of the year. And 28th power play goal on the season. 6-0 goal coming at 14:23. Austin Murr, his 11th. From Manning, a correction from Cates and Matt Stannon. And the 7-0 goal is where TJ, he wrapped up his hat trick here in the first period. And on the assist for Luke Manning and Brody Swanson on that assist. And the Ponies, as mentioned, have picked up, let's see, 3 power play goals, 26, 27, and 28. And they do have about a minute and 33 seconds to serve, as Austin Murr will be in the penalty box to start the second period. But 7-0 Stillwater and the rematch. And the Ponies put 5 up on the Raiders at Highland Arena, and 7 so far here tonight in 17 minutes.
Well, what I don't understand, and I haven't been around down here in the cities to watch many Suburban East Conference games, but are the other teams that much weaker than everything else than Stillwater? I mean, come on, this is one of the biggest conferences in the state of Minnesota, and Cretin's up there in second in the conference, and they beat everybody else but Stillwater. The only loss they have is that first game. Yeah, against
they're, and they're also the number 2 team right in Section 6 behind Edina. And it has been a pretty good race. The Ponies will find out again when they get the rematch with the White Bear Lake on Thursday night. No, those standings, as mentioned at the top of the show, as we watch the little guys skating on the ice. Cretin Derham Hall at 13-1, Stillwater 13-1, White Bear Lake 10-3-1, and then Woodbury. But the Ponies defeated Woodbury here the other night, put up 9 on them. And then Moundsview about 500. Park Cottage Grove, Forest Lake, Roseville, and Ace Ridge. And West Walls, Raptors having a tough year.
Yeah, well, see, you know, that's the problem and the competition. That's why, you know, your coach at Stillwater set up this schedule to have it right at the end and then play Holy Family before the section start to just see what kind of a team you have. I remember old Larry Ross used to do that all back in the day with the International Falls Broncos and always play a top team right before the section start to see what you're really made of. And if this is what the Ponies are made of tonight and what we've seen this first period, look out, everybody else in the state, is the way I say it.
Well, the Ponies 19-3 looking for their 20th win of the year. mentioned the JV went by way of the Ponies. Luke Munson getting the hat trick. And Matthew McGinley had a couple of goals. We'll probably see Matthew in the third period. And also getting a pair of goals with Jack Ryan. Seth will probably see him in the third period. They played two periods in the junior varsity game. And Joey Pitty also had a goal. The Ponies won by a score of 8-0. Jesse Brown tossing a shutout, stopping 13 shots for the Cretin Derham Hall Raiders. 22-1
has
on
Mitch,
the season.
Mitch Bailey played it all this year, Tom?
He has played, I think, twice he's come on in a relief role. He hasn't started any. Jesse Brown, our junior varsity goaltender, he has started two games for the Ponies, but Mitch Bailey has come on in relief in a couple of blowouts to get some playing time.
The world is a different world today, and it's a different kid you're dealing with. And you really have to have two goalies all the time.
Oh, yeah.
Now, I mean, you really do. Because one could go down, like, you know, Magnuson has gone into la-la land here. Not at, you know, he's had played great all year, but he's having a bad night. No question about it. And the Ponies are making him feel bad, and he's down, he's out. But they don't have a guy down that's played any hockey to dig in deep to bring back that just even at the end of period with 5 minutes just to give Magnuson to get his head back. You know, and this is the problem. And Jimmy knew this coming. I felt, well, talking to him before the game, Jim O'Neill, he felt a little shaky about this goalie situation because I asked him about the second string goalie. I mean, have you played him? Have you given him any chance to play? I mean, this is it. This is high school hockey at its best. And it starts back in the net. Every hockey game does.
Yep.
I don't care. And I asked, they asked Ed Olczyk when he was on NBC doing the Wild game.
Detroit. Yeah.
And they asked him, what do you think the biggest change is of the Wild this year compared to last year? And he mentioned everything but Dubnyk.
Yeah.
And Dubnyk has been just fantastic.
Yep.
And he's sparked everything. Now, you know, granted, there's five other guys on the ice out there, but if that goalie isn't sharp and isn't hot, it can change the whole complexion and momentum of the game by one bad goal. So this is what we saw, you know, Cretin Derham Hall happened right at the beginning, and Stillwater's got the team to just keep coming and coming and coming and controlling the puck in their offensive zone so much that the Raiders were just stymied.
And this Pony broadcast here on Club 1220 and on VAC Channel 15 brought to you by Stillwater Motors, the First National Bank, River Falls, Pro-Life Across America, and also brought to you by Stillwater Family Dental, and also brought to you by RBC Wealth Management. And we thank the good folks at RBC, Tom Sagasaur, and Tony Novellini, and Matt Doman, and the rest of the crew at RBC. Thank them for making possible our television broadcast as well. Our broadcast here tonight and our special appearance by my broadcast partner and longtime friend, Russ Bladdy, made possible by Manelli's by the Lake, downtown Forest Lake.
Continue the tradition of great food, great Italian food, at Vanelli's by the lake, downtown Forest Lake, where they feature the special every Wednesday crab, all the crab you can eat on Wednesday nights and Friday, Saturday, prime rib specials at Vanelli's by the lake.
Other games going on tonight around the SEC, and as White Bear Lake is at East Ridge, Charlton and Moundsview non-conference game, North St. Paul Park Cottage Grove non-conference game, and of course our contest here. Only scores we do have in, and we have to go to the Metro East, Bloomington, St. Thomas Academy. And Tommy Vanelli's crew has been awesome of late. They beat Matamidi and Hillmarie in succession. They're leading Vanille St. Margaret's at home 3-0.
And yeah, well, I was eating at Vanelli's by the lake on Sunday night and talking to Ronnie. And Tommy's really got this deal turned around now over there at St. Thomas Academy. They got a heck of a team, too. They beat Hillmarie this week 5-1. They beat Cretin Derham Hall 5-1. They're on a roll, and they really put it to Matamidi back into the situation. And, you know, Tommy Vanelli's been around coaching in this league for a long time, and he knows how to get his teams playing. This is the time of the year you want your team at your max, just like the Stillwater Ponies look here right now. I'm sure all the coaches over there got to be really proud of their players playing the way they are because they're playing against a good team in Cretin, and they could meet them again coming in the section finals.
I saw their JV here the other day. I was doing Augsburg and St. Thomas men's hockey. We saw a JV game between Hillmarie and St. Thomas Academy, and the Cadets won that one 1-0 in overtime. So they got some good kids coming up as well. They're the number one seed in their section. We'll take a look at those sections in just a bit. And a bit of a surprise And it is St. Michael Albertville losing to Farmington 1-0. That's the first period score. Chask over Bloomington, Kennedy 5-1. And let's see, Coon Rapids and Andover 1-1. And Park Cottage Grove leading North St. Paul by a score of 1-0. Those are the only scores that we have in so far here tonight. Metro East Conference, we gave you some of the matchups in the Metro East. Hillmarie on tap. But St. Thomas Academy with this hot streak, they are just a half a game back. Hillmarie 9-1-1. The Cadets are 9-2. And then Charton having a good year. Jimmy's crew is having a 16-6 year, 8-4 in conference. Then Matamidi, Zephyr's been sliding of late. And then North St. Paul, Hastings, South St. Paul, Sibley, and Henry Sibley. Redmond at South St. Paul tonight at Doug Hoog Arena. We mentioned the STA Benilde St. Margaret's game. Ridgefield, Southwest Christian, and Henry Sibley. Charton and Moundsbury, North St. Paul, and Park Cottage Grove. Speaking of Ridgefield, Southwest Christian, they combine. What do you think the future is for that Ridgefield program?
Well, it's really sad. You know, I go back a long time ago when Darby Hendrickson and his brother played there. And, you know, Larry Hendrickson did so much for that program to get that beautiful arena over there.
Yep.
We're talking 30, 40 years ago.
Sure.
You know, and back in Jake McCoy, who was such a great Ridgefield guy, played in the U.S. team with him back in 1967, 68. They have just had a different clientele of people moving into Ridgefield. They do not have any numbers.
No.
And Lenny Vannelli Jr. is coaching the girls' team over there at Holy Angels. They practice there at that arena. It's a beautiful arena, the Ridgefield Arena. They got two beautiful rinks there. Their biggest show of the week is the Ridgefield Magicians that play out of there.
Right.
Junior A team that features 14 guys, high school kids from Minnesota yet on that team. The sad thing is they all got, this is why I'm working up with the Cloquet Minnesota Wilderness up there. All the goalies are, look at here.
Oh,
hey, speaking of a goalie, an old goalie.
Yeah, who took
Johnny.
He took way too many shots without a mask.
Yeah, no, he Paul had Osby. A mask. He came in when the mask was in. That's Paul Osby, our good friend. And he must have known because I didn't even text him, tell him I was going to be here with you at the game. It's good to see him.
Visiting with Tom Sagas, who are down there.
Oh, yeah. Well, you know, he's a scout now, works with Neil Sheehy and scouting players. And, of course, he's been up, and that's where that's what the junior league is all about, for the scouts to look at him. And I think the Magicians will keep the arena going, but as far as the program for Ridgefield High School hockey is in question.
All right, we talked about this being the final week of the regular season. And for Cretin Derham Hall, they have Forest Lake up at Lickshed Arena in Forest Lake on Thursday, then home against Holy Angels on Saturday. And the Ponies have White Bear Lake here at home on Thursday. And then we head to Holy Family on Saturday. A reminder, that game, the Stillwater Ponies and the Fire of Holy Family, will have it on Club 1220 KLBB, but it'll also be audio and video stream, but it won't be on cable. You have to go to our website, tjsportsonline.net, and the link will be there to the broadcast. This broadcast, a presentation of Club 1220, VAC, and also my company, TJ Broadcast Services. And again, the website is tjsportsonline.net. So we'll keep harping on that. If you want to watch and listen to the game on Saturday afternoon, you'll have to tune in to my website. And section girls hockey is going on right now over at Aldridge Arena. And we'll see if we can't pick up the scores. But the first game at 5:30 was Hillmarie taking on the Roseville Raiders. And the second game was White Bear Lake and Moundsbury. Now the championship game will be on Friday. And the winner will advance to the state high school hockey tournament. Stillwater girls lost to Roseville here the other night. A game we broadcast here on Club 1220. They lost 7-2 to the Roseville Raiders. And a disappointing finish to the season. They finished with 9 wins, 15 losses, and 2 ties. 7-0 our score here, and we have yet to even start the second period. We're awaiting the return of these two teams. I'm Tom Worship. Angie Mark Waters, our engineer, back in studio. And nice to have you along, wherever you might be watching or listening here tonight. We're going to take our second intermission break. And we'll be back with the start of the second period after these reminders again on Club 1220 KLBB and on VAC Channel 15 here in the Valley.
Stillwater Boys Hockey is brought to you in part by Lakeview Hospital Stillwater Medical Group and the Boys Hockey Boosters and their business supporter, RBC Wealth Management.
ready to do this?
Nah, I'm kind of nervous.
Don't be.
Is this place kind of sketchy, though?
Nah, man, I smoke here every day.
All right,
let's do this.
Want some of this?
All right.
Wait, hold on. Do I really want to do this? People die from this every day. Short term or long term, I'm not going to start now. So I'm good, bro.
I won't bow down to no man.
And we welcome you back to the Blizzard Rink, and it'll be Seth Isley in goal to our left, and Mike Magnuson will remain in goal to our right. 7-0 in favor of the Ponies. Ponies are one man short out on the penalty kill. Mapstone, Bjugstad, Sagasaur, and Cates. Cates wins the draw and cleared off the boards, and Bjugstad gets it out to neutralize. And the Raiders try to regroup back in their own zone. Picked off. Sagasaur looking for four, and a pass save by Magnuson. Had our 11th shorthanded goal of the season.
Yeah, another turnover by Cretin Derham Hall right off the bat of this period.
And back behind his own end is Daniel Magnuson. Gets away from Sagasaur. Coming to center, a headman pass into the zone. Down that wing is Gibberlin. And Joseph Gibberlin back behind the point. And that got triple teamed and lost it. Now taken away by Gibberlin. And he is taken down. A tackle in the corner there by Bjergstedt. And there is Joseph Gleason, or Mike, John Gleason, goes up top, there's a shot, and that's one of the goal. Matt Gleason against the far side boards, feeds the point, but nobody's home. Magnuson has to go back into his own zone. 45 seconds to go on the Raider power play, and the puck inside the pony zone. There's Matt Gleason on his backhand, coming down the wing, stops. He drops it up top for John Gleason. Goes wing near side for Magnuson, shot, and it's armed out of there by Seth Lisley. Bukes head for the ponies, off the board to the line, held in by Magnuson. Momentarily, now come free and out to center ice. Raiders get onside. Matt Gleason into the zone. Boy, he's a good stick handler. Here's TJ Sagasaur, short-handed for Matt Tennant. And the Ponies are changing up penalty killers. Matt Gleason into the zone, down the left wing. The young freshman does a 180 in the corner. Goes up top to the point and out front on a shot taken by Michael Murphy. Steered away by Noble Lady out of the zone and all the way down the ice.
I asked Jimmy where the Magnusons are from. Gleason's are from, and he said Highland Park kids.
Highland Park's having a pretty good year.
Yeah, I see that.
And the offensive zone carried in by Jack English, one of the co-captains, senior, against the near side boards in the pony zone. Both teams are back at full strength. 7-0, 15 minutes to go, second period. And at center ice, Ostermer dropped. And that's going to be a penalty against Jack English. And there's a shot, and that is kicked out of there by Michael Magnuson.
As we know, the Cretin Derham Hall kids come from all over, you know. And English is from Woodbury. He drove here tonight. He didn't even take the school bus here. And the Raiders are on a penalty kill again. Who is that in the box for them?
Jack English, senior, winger on that third line.
Nice kid. Plans on going to school at the University of Minnesota or Wisconsin next year, but no hockey career, he said.
Manning on the faceoff, offensive zone. The Ponies are on the power play, and the Raiders send it all the way back down the ice.
And they did the first thing right. They won that faceoff in their end and get it out of there.
Data with a puck from Luke Manning. Manning already has, what, 4 or 5 assists. I'm losing track. I'm running out of room on my score sheet. Noah Cates in the near corner. Cates, Manning, Sagasaur, Bukes, and it's standing out there. High slot for Jesse. He's got a power play goal. Jesse goes wing far side for Stanton. He's got a goal. And they play it wide down in that far corner. Noah Cates does a 180, leaves it there. Out of the corner for Sagasaur. TJ up top, Jesse, a blast, and it's up over the net. And a deep rebound up along the fireside boards, clear the line, and out of the zone.
How'd you like to see a shot like that come at your head, Tom? Boy, did he let that go, but he missed the net.
Jesse got the most powerful shot of the team. Standing at center ice. Matt on the move. Into the zone. Those long legs. And he's taken down to the blue line. But carried on against the near side boards. Inside the Raiders zone. They go up top to Bjergstad. Trying to spread the ice. As they usually go 1-3-1 on the power play. Puck back behind the net. And they put out front. Sagasur takes a hit. And a big pile up in the crease. And finally, the play is whistled down with 51 seconds to go in the power play. And we went over to Aldrich Arena. Here are the scores. Hill Murray headed to the section final in girls hockey. They beat Roseville 4-0. And the other game underway right now, it is Moundsview and Whiteville 2-2. And they're about to start the second period. So Hill Murray against the Bears or the Mustangs for the section 4 AA girls title. Kaufman into the zone. Coming with Joe Raleigh. Raleigh, Murr, Kaufman, Nobilini, and Brushy out there. Puck down in the corner, up top for Nobilini. There's Mapstone with a shot. And I haven't seen in our era, haven't called Tom Brushy's name very much here in the hockey game. Hopefully Tommy B is okay.
Well, they've been playing pretty much 3-4 lines shifting all the time. They don't need to really, you know, mix things around. They got everything going for them their way. Cretin Derham Hall, on the other hand, is mixing lines around.
Off the faceoff, there's Raleigh on that wing. Turns and fires, hits bodies. Rebound tipped to the line, Nobilini to hold it in. Down in the corner for Kaufman, walks the goal line. Behind the net, in the near corner for Raleigh. Up top for Mapstone. Jack backs it off the boards, picked off by the Raiders. Sent away to center ice, short-headed. Backfield coming a two-on-two into the zone. Pass out front for Jack English and a save by Isley. And I think there's going to be a penalty against the Ponies. We got a hooking call, yep, at the 3:59 mark of the second period. And will pull be four on four. Jack Mapstone's going to get a two-minute amount. And the Raiders will be on the power play here in just about 5 seconds.
That was kind of a questionable penalty on that.
Yep.
You know, and so far the refs have been calling a pretty good game, not a lot of penalties. I think there were two or three only in the first period, so. But we already had two in the second period here.
Four on four, and the Raiders will get a body back here in about 4 seconds. Off the faceoff, Eisler with a save, and it's cleared by Sagasaur out of the zone and all the way down the ice.
That's probably the best save he's had of the night, Tom. I mean, he really had to be alert and focused on that play.
And it is McGinley with the penalty for the, correction, Mapstone with the penalty for the Ponies. Bob said Matthew McGinley, but he's number 15. Here the Ponies clear it all the way back down the ice. Parker Wadley drives it all the way back into the Raiders zone. And Coach Dean is changing up his penalty killers as the Raiders coming right to left into the offensive zone. Here comes Johnny Gleason. He gets double teamed and lost it. And it cleared again by the Stillwater Ponies all the way down the ice. Second
period. Well, the Ponies are even putting on pressure. Look at that, they're forechecking one guy even when they're playing the penalty kill. I mean, they're just going after these Raiders left and right.
2-on-2 coming back the other way. Center pass right through the skates of Magnuson. Comes the line. Pony zone and out to center ice.
Well, Magnuson had a great opportunity there, Daniel, and he just couldn't catch the pass. And it's so much important about this game of passing and catching passes.
Here comes Manning, short-handed, walking the goal line, offensive zone, and killing some time. He's pinned by a double team against that back wall. And out of the near corner, here come the Raiders and out the center ice, and the speedy Johnny Gleason into the offensive zone. Poke checked away there by Joey Raleigh and set by Michael Kaufman all the way down the ice.
Great job again by Stillwater breaking up the Cretin Derham Hall Raiders right at their blue line, turning it over and getting control of the puck.
And it'll be the Raiders icing the puck on the power play, which is a no-no. 11:21 to go in the second period, still 7-0. 21 seconds to go on the penalty to Jack Mapstone. By the way, coming up this weekend, it's been a busy winter here in the Valley with the Hockey Day Minnesota, the Sticks in Stillwater for the Mites, the Skate for the Roses with the girls, and Brian's Restaurant is going to have their annual bocce ball tournament coming up this weekend.
Oh, yeah.
Over 60 teams will be coming here to the Stillwater area for bocce ball. I'm not sure what, is that like bowling?
No, Tom.
I have no nothing about
it. We don't have the time for me to explain it to you now, okay. But I will.
All right. Up the left wing near side, but that begins Saturday morning at 10 o'clock as into the offensive zone, carried in by Michael Murphy. And the power play opportunity for the Raiders goes by the boards. 5-6-man runners from in that far corner inside the Pony zone, comes to the line. And Kate to take it away, 2-on-1. And then the referee or the linesman runs into him. Noah had a breakaway and the linesman took him out of the play. Clean breakup. As the puck back inside the Pony zone in the near faceoff circle. Into the slot, there's a shot, 6 save by Isley. As Grayson Melage took the shot on Big Seth. And he has his 9th save of the second game. Shots and goal 22-9.
Well, he's had to come up big at times this year, Tom. Seth Isley is a good goaltender. He's 6'3", 190 pounds. He's being sought after by a lot of teams. And like I say, he's working with the Austin Bruins down there in Austin, Minnesota on his off time.
He was voted one of the best goaltenders in the Elite League this past fall out there at Mariucci Arena. That's some good competition. Back in the top goals against average in the Elite League. Back at the other end, it is, well, Magnuson to make the save. Yes.
I'd rather see a big tall guy like that playing tight end or wide receiver or something for the Ponies rather than hockey during the fall, but that's the way the world is today.
And here's a line of Huber, Swanson, and Noah Kate centering this line. Coach Diaz changing up his units, and we'll see more changes out front. And right through the skates of Brody Swanson. Brody has one assist since he came back from his leg injury, his knee injury. Map zone back into his own zone. Up the left wing boards. Tipped down eyes by Logan Huber. Coach Diaz arguing that, and he has a good argument. That was not an icing call. Puck was dumped in on the Raiders side of the red line, but the...
Well, Matt's not going to win that argument.
No.
So he might as well not argue it. But the point is, Noah Cates had the puck, and I mean to tell you, when he could, if he would have wanted to run in that referee there a little while back, he'd have been gone free on the net.
Oh, yeah. Matt Gleason and Noah Cates on the draw, and Noah wins that faceoff. Puck in that far corner, off the dasher board to the line. It's held in by Johnny Gleason, and he gets double teamed and lost it. Pony's coming back. Cates on the rush. On the wing for Huber. Logan into the zone, down the right wing. Drop pass, Cates. Noah to the drop pass for Jesse Mjungstedt. Jesse in the corner, trying to go down low for Cates. Into the slot, Brody shot, and it hits bodies. And the rebound comes to the line. Huber with a shot, and that's one of the goal. And back behind the Raider net, and pin against that back wall, cleared up along the near side board for Matt Gleason. Gleason off the wall and out to center ice. Not far enough for icing. And the Ponies have to hurry, and Mapstone gets to the puck first. Matt Gleason on the forecheck. And the puck off into the near corner for Logan Huber. Huber's pass picked up by Johnny Gleason into the slot. Raiders of the puck, high slot. There's a shot, it's bodies, and it comes free to the line and out to center ice.
That was a sloppy turnover in the Ponies zone, and turnover by the Ponies. And I'm sure Coach D don't like to see that kind of stuff.
Puck up along the near side board for Logan Huber. At the end of his shift, gets it out to center ice. And Noah Case will send it into the zone. Here comes the line change. Five new bodies out there. There's Matt Sannett in on the forecheck. Raiders get away from him, play it up the boards, and wanting to break up the rush at his own blue line. Novellini going back for the Ponies, up the wall for Sannett. Sannett leaves it there for Luke Manning. Manning coming with TJ. Manning on his backhand, walks to the in front. Shot saved by Magnuson, and he holds on. Manning already with 4 assists tonight, and he tried to get Ponies first goal. Well, and Magnuson covers up on the pipe.
He's a left-handed shot coming in there to the left of goaltender Magnuson. And he had a perfect opportunity to stick it in, but now we're starting to see this Cretin Derham Hall goalie tighten up a little bit and be focused.
Off the faceoff in the Raiders zone, up along the right wing board, Novellini from center ice. Joey will drive it back into the CDH zone, and the first person back is Billy Hanza. Hanza off in the corner, taken away by Stanton. Stanton, far corner, offensive zone, at the half wall. Matt out front, and his puck checked away and taken to the line and out to center ice. Raiders coming back into the offensive zone. And here comes Hanza, backhand shot out front. Block rebound, shot again. Pad save Isley. And loose puck right of the crease, and it just trickles wide.
See how nice and far he came out to challenge that shooter in that play. Great save by Isley.
Wiley back behind his own net. Left wing for Luke Manning. Manning plays it to the near side board. There's Stanton. Stanton checks traffic. Headman pass too far for Sagasaur all the way down the ice. And an icing call against Stillwater. As we played 9 minutes of the second period. No goals in this period, but 7 in the first period, 3 by TJ Sagasaur. One shot, 10 goal, 24-10.
Well, the Raiders got 5 shots on goal so far in this period. They had 5 though all of the first period, so They're playing a little bit better right now, but the Ponies seem to be just kind of going lackadaisical out there.
Yeah, they're in cruise control. Here comes Adam Isley. Isley out there with Swanson. And let's see, who's the other winger? Parker Detko. Detko, he fires from a bad angle. And Magnuson makes the save on the far side plank to hold on and get a whistle on a staff bridge of point.
Another thing Magnuson's doing this period, he's not letting any rebounds get away from him, Tom. So far, he's controlled every rebound. Isley has done it well, too. That's such a big thing with goalies. You've got to get them to work on controlling those rebounds.
Off the faceoff inside the CDH zone, Ponies with a good two-man aggressive forward check comes to that wing and backhand to the line, but not out. It's held in by Joey Rodley, our sophomore defenseman. Adam Isley in on the forecheck. He overskates, picked up by the Raiders. Played to the wall, but not out. Again, they hold it in, and then it's poked free. Coming back, the Raiders into the offensive zone down the wing. There's a shot, Isley with a save on a shot taken by John A. Buckingham.
Well, Buckingham, and the puck was kind of rolling on him when he let it go. Isley was out, cut the angle, and then again, no rebound by Seth. He's just controlling the puck really well. And at this time of the year, if there's one thing you want your goalie doing, it's controlling, no rebounds. You just got to hang on to that puck and don't give him a rebound.
And Coffin out there with Austin Murr and Luke Manning, the puck at center ice. Here comes Coffin over skates. Murr feeds the wing. Logan Huber's on this line. Manning is taking a rest. Sent into the offensive zone. Coffin into the forecheck. Huber in the near corner. Back behind the net for Austin Murr, who's got to go. And there is Huber on the forecheck. Taken away by Daniel Magnuson. Magnuson up the right wing and out to center ice as Mapstone on the intercept. Pass for Murr a little bit too far. And walked into the zone, down that slot. Here comes Magnuson again. In on goal, shot, and deflected by Isley with that paddle, and up over the net.
He uses that stick really well down there. He keeps control of his goalie stick so well and booms the puck. When it does hit that goalie stick, it goes into the corner, not out in front.
Magnuson in his own zone. Mapstone for the point with a blast and a waffle pad. Same there by Michael Magnuson. Out of the corner, Huber goes up top to the point. Mapstone a one-timer and a chest wide. Puck in the near corner. Played by the Ponies up top. Held in by Michael Coffin. And out of the corner, out front. And a one-timer by Michael Coffin and Magnuson coming up on the short side. And he cut off the angle, and Michael didn't have a lot to shoot at.
Well,
and a save by Magnuson.
I tell all the guys at the Wilderness, always shoot for the blocker side, up high, stick side. I mean, that you saw how much was open there. You see how much is open on the faceoff here, yeah. Tom. It's wide open to that goaltender's right.
Manning on the faceoff, and the faceoff. There's Novelandi with a shot, and Magnuson with a save. Wasn't on goal. Joey has been kind of snake bitten. He's still looking for that first goal of the year. And he's the only one of the regulars that has not gotten a goal so far this season. Joey Raleigh got his first here the other night against Woodbury. Ponies with the puck in the offensive zone. Cycle it on the near side. Let's see if they go weak side. Novelandi with a shot in the high slot. Turning and Cates, Noah out front. And that went off his own body, off his own teammate, Matt Stannon. And a shot for the point went wide. And a shot taken there by Joey Rodley. Raiders back the other way and broke it up at center on the rush. Manning stood up at the blue line. Santa walks it back in. Manning was still in that offensive zone. It's an offside call against Stillwater with 5:41 to go in the second period. And again, 7-0.
Stillwater's had 7 shots so far this period, and they got about 3 of them in the last minute of play because they had total control of the puck in Cretin Derham Hall zone. And winning that faceoff is everything.
Well, looks like short shifts. Here comes Murr, Coffin, and Sagastor on this line. And the Raiders with the puck. Hitman pass broken up by Jesse Bukestad at center ice. And play to the near side boards. Wildly to get to it. Plays it ahead into the zone. Here comes TJ with Austin Murr. Sagastor fires, save, rebound Murr. And he put it in. No, Magnuson makes the save.
Well, the puck bounced up off the initial shot and went down into his pad.
He went into the goal, but they wave it off, and then the frustration by the Raiders.
Well, the goalie thought he had it in his equipment, and
yep.
Then when he got up, it dropped down into the net, and that's when the Ponies thought they got the goal. But the whistle was already blown by then.
And it looks like we have a penalty against Matt Gleason. We'll have offsetting minors. As Kaufman's going to go off, Gleason's going to go off. After that whistle, the sticks came up a little bit. And we'll skate 4-on-4. And a referee talking with Mr. Bielenberg. How far do you and Bob go back?
Oh, man. And then I saw Andy Anderson when I came in the door over there. He's taking tickets. He's an old hockey rep that's been around for ages. And then I saw Bielenberg, and I just about flipped out. I haven't seen him from since when he worked with Doug Johnson in Let's Play Hockey about 5 years ago. But there's a rink rat.
Oh,
there is an old rink rat going way back. And he's got a great article in the Stillwater program. You got to look at it. It's called The Rise of a Hockey Town. Bob Bielenberg started it all out. He was here 60 years ago when hockey started here in Stillwater.
Well, I know he's awfully proud of his grandkids. His grandkids play for the Northfield Raiders, boys and girls. And Northfield, I think, is the number one seed either in boys or girls.
Tom,
they're winning the Big Nine.
He was working with Bob Utech when Utech actually started out doing the Let's Play Hockey paper years ago. He was one of Utech's friends.
All right, let's see. We do have an offsetting minor. Somebody's got a double. We got, here we go with Bob.
Well, we're playing 4-on-4 here.
No, 5-on-4.
At 11:37 of the second period to Cretin Derham Hall, number 5, Matt Gleason, a minor for roughing, to Stillwater's number 25,
TJ.
The goal. The goal.
And we got a goal here. We're listening to Bob and watching TJ put on his magic.
Yeah.
And I think he got number 4. At first, we thought Magnus had made the save, and Michael is still down on his back.
I think he twisted his knee turning around trying to get the puck. He had a heck of a shot come at him from TJ, and I mean to tell you, this is the problem with playing the puck in the crease nowadays. You know, I don't know what bright person came up with that. I asked Billy Kronchneibel, the head of the referees, which one of the brains came up with that deal. And, of course, the NHL allows it now, so high school hockey's got to allow it now, and that's what happens. Your goalie gets run into and gets hurt.
Yeah. So, and Caitlin Sunday, our athletic trainer, is out to take a look at Michael Magnuson.
We might
see. But it's 8-0 Ponies time of this goal. Will be 12:04 in the second period. And TJ took the initial shot.
I was talking to his daddy sitting over there with Paul Ospie. And they're both trying to help. Look at, they got players helping Magnuson up. He's in rough shape.
Yeah.
Let me tell you, he's in rough shape. We're going to see. Look at that.
Unable to put any weight on.
This could really kill the rest of the hockey season for the Raiders.
And their goaltender will be Manny Hertel or Hurdle.
Yeah, Manny Hurdle Bauman.
And he's a senior.
And he hasn't played at all hardly this year, so he's in for a rude awakening.
It's his left leg or left knee, and
that's what I saw.
Really struggling.
I saw him twist that knee, and it didn't look good. And they're got over on the Stillwater side, and the trainer's looking at him.
Now he collapses out there in the runway.
I don't know, Tom. I don't like the situation about playing in the puck in the crease all the time, and goalies getting run into. Granted, they get run into mostly by their own teammates, but a guy's got to take control in his own net. He just can't have it, or that's the end result.
5-on-4 for the Raiders for another minute and 34 seconds. Still haven't heard from Bob, who got that last goal for us. TJ at least will get one up point, if not. Here we go.
Number 11, Noah Cage, the assist to number 22, TJ Zagasaur. Time of the goal.
All right, for Noah, that is his first goal of this hockey game. He's had two or three different assists.
And that was a shorthanded goal again.
Yeah, shorthanded goal, and for the Ponies, that's their 11th shorthanded goal of the year. And for Noah, that is his fourth shorthanded goal of the year. He has four of our 11 shorthanded goals. So three power play goals, one shorthanded goal out of our eight. And still 55 seconds remaining in the Raider power play with 4:18 to go in the period. And the faceoff will come outside the Pony zone, yep. And the Ponies will send out his penalty killers. There's Austin Murr. And Park Iwata. TJ Sagasaur and Jesse Bjungstedt. And the faceoff into the offensive zone. There's Kramer with a shot. Isley the same rebound. They hack at it. And Isley with those big legs covers up the entire net. When you're 6'5 and you have those long legs,
well, and that's,
you cover up pipe to pipe.
You bet. And you got legs like that, you can stretch your legs. Pipe to pipe is right. Cover the whole low part of the cage. Can't get a puck. You got to be able to lift it up like Jason Zucker does.
Puck against the near side boards and the Raiders holding the offensive zone. This Kramer in that high slot. Kramer's pass to the point for Michael Murphy. Shot, tip just wide. A tip attempt by English right out front. Just went wide of the pipe. Puck in the near corner. Still half a minute to go. Raider power play. There's Murphy again with a shot, and it's deflected wide off to that corner. English, and he goes to his knees and lost the puck, but picked up by the Raiders. They go up top near side of Murphy. Shot deflected on goal, and Isley with a save. And the rebound swept away by the Ponies. And here comes Sagasaur back. Sends it into the CDH zone. Defenseman goes down. Sagasaur with the puck along with Austin Murr. Austin goes rink wide. And on the back check, it's broken up by the Raiders. And back they come 2-on-2. English into the zone. Drop pass, shot, and it's wide. And a shot taken by Nick Aron. And the puck inside the Pony zone near corner. And left to right, here comes Stillwater. And Murr to set it back into the Raiders zone. CDH regrouping, back they come. And broken up, we're gonna have a penalty against the Ponies on a tripping call.
Yeah, the ref's calling pretty close right
Logan,
now.
Logan Huber got called for the trip.
And a player went down,
call, excuse me.
He came from behind him and the player went down and referee standing right there and throws his arm up and the Raiders are back on a power play. I'm sure they'd like to get a goal here, but the way Isley's playing, I'll tell you, he wants a shutout and he's playing great.
Jesse Brown got the shutout in the JV game on an 8-0 score. Face off to left of Big Seth. Matt Gleason and Noah Cates. Buzzer sounds, some discussion. 2 minute minor for slashing. They want to get an explanation.
Bob needs an explanation. He's getting up there in age a little bit. He got to understand his stuff. I know the feeling.
He's a great guy. He works the press box for football too. Terry Murphy and the rest of the crew.
Well, you know, that's why old guys like us got to be have something to do. It's either the senior center or here at the hockey rink. So take your choice.
Off the faceoff and play against that back wall behind. Seth taken away by Ducktail. Parker coming out of his own zone, short-handed. And Parker into the zone, turns on the Jets, fires, and a save there by Baumann. And the puck back behind the Raider net.
First shot on him and a nice save. He just kicked out a rebound right to the guy.
We say Hertel Baumann or just Baumann?
I guess, I don't know. I don't know how to say those kind of names. But it looks like Hertel Baumann to me.
Okay. We'll just call him Manny.
Right. That's what Jimmy calls him.
Here's Detko trying to clear the zone, and he does out to center ice. Nice job by Parker. Back into his own zone is Nick Davidson, the freshman for the Raiders. They got a couple of freshman centers on this Raider team. And out of center, here comes Luke, shorthanded. In a goal, shot, and a save by Manny. And the puck taken away by Manning. Through the skates of Stanton and not to center ice.
I watched Manny in warm-ups. I thought he looked pretty good. I don't know why Jimmy didn't put him in earlier. He made a great save that time, Tom.
So a shorthanded opportunity by Luke Manning, stopped by Manny Hertelbaumann.
Yeah, but that was a pure lone break.
Yeah.
All the way in on the goalie, all alone.
Back in the Pony zone. Noblani retreating. Joey off the back wall along the near side boards in the Stillwater zone. And it comes low down in the corner for Tucker Cruz, senior winger. Cruz fettering pass out front, tipped away and wide of the goal by Joey Buckingham. Buckingham drops it down low in the corner. They crisscross and go up top to the point. Back on that wing. Shot scoring on the wing.
Boy,
is Michael Kramer goes top shelf. And he made Seth Isley on the stick side. And the Raiders had their 17th power play goal of the season. This one coming at the 15:37 mark. Michael Kramer getting the goal, and that's his seventh of the year.
Well, they won the faceoff in the end there, and that really helped the Raiders get control of it. Of course, they were on a power play situation. Seth was, I thought, a little back too far in the net. He completely didn't see that puck at all. It might have been a deflect right in front of him, but still he was a little back too far and went right over his right shoulder.
And off the faceoff is Rapstone to drive it in the zone.
Number 22, Michael Kramer, with the assist to number 9, Mike Murphy. Time of the...
So Kramer from Murphy at 15:37. Again for Kramer, seventh of the year for the Raiders, their 17th power play goal of the year. 1 minute to go, and they get it back from the point of blast, taken by Jesse Bjelkstead, but it went through a lot of traffic, so we'll have to wait and see if there was a deflection. But Jesse Bjelkstead has himself another assist, and...
Well, I was just saying to myself, watching that play develop, that puck gets to Bjelkstead out at the blue line. Man, he's got to get himself out on top of that crease. He never even saw that puck. There was a lot of traffic in front of him. But you, this is the way you play. You know there's traffic in front of you. If you lose sight of the puck, you know you're out far enough and got the angle cut that he can't score from there.
So if it is Jesse, that means a little through the air.
Number three,
yep,
Jesse Bjelkstead,
is 11.
With the assist to number 11, Noah Cage. And number 13, Austin Murr, time to the pony goal.
And 16:04 the time of that goal. It is now 9-1 in favor of the Ponies. And the Ponies send it up the near side boards and a little bit too far for Parker Dutko, and that'll be an icing call. So it was 7-0 at the end of one. At 12:04, Noah Cage gets in the scoring column from TJ Sagasaur. And then at 16:04, Jesse Bjelkstead picking up his second goal of the game. First one was unassisted. The second one from Noah Cates and Austin Murr, 32-15. A 2-1 shot on goal advantage for Stillwater. And off the faceoff, there's a shot that's blocked out front by Michael Kaufman. Picked up by Brody Swanson. Swanson for Kaufman into the zone, down the wing, on his backhand. And it's broken up temporarily by Liam Ryan. They both go down against that back wall, out of that far corner of the Raider zone, into the slot, through the skates of Swanson, and back out to center ice.
Boy, I tell you, the Ponies have been getting a lot of odd man rushes here this whole game.
Here's Swanson with a shot, and Herdell Barman with the save, and there's the horn. And we've played 34 minutes of hockey, and we've seen 10 goals put up on the board, 33-15, and again, two for the Ponies here in this period. And again, you mentioned they were kind of in cruise control, but this last 5 minutes, they kind of stepped it up once again.
Yeah, they did, Tom. And once they got caught in a couple of shorthand situations, they capitalized on that by getting a shorthanded goal right off the bat and, you know, getting a lone break in on that goaltender. And they could have had another one, you know. And Manny, the second string goaltender for the Raiders, came up big to help out. But I thought at the beginning of the period, Cretin came out flying a little bit. You know, Stillwater was just playing so-so, and then they turned on the Jets and got it going again at the end of the period here. Shots are, like you said, 33-15 in favor of the Ponies, and scores 9-1.
All right, our first intermission break, and we'll have more from the Blizzard Arena. Blizzard Rink, the St. Croix Battle Rec Center, in 2 minutes. This is Suburban East Conference Hockey on Club 1220 KLBB and on VAC Channel 15 here in the Valley. Back in 2 minutes.
Stillwater Boys Hockey is brought to you in part by Lakeview Hospital, Stillwater Medical Group, and the Boys Hockey Boosters and their business supporter, RBC Wealth Management.
Lots of beer and vodka.
Yeah, I just paid Josh $20 for weed. We're gonna get so high.
Oh, do you think Josh gave us some more alcohol? I want to get totally wasted.
Yeah, maybe, but my sister has a fake ID. Maybe she could get it for us.
I wish my brother was that cool. My brother only buys me cigarettes.
Well, we better get to class.
Well, see you at the party.
All right, cool.
Thank you.
And again, we welcome you back to the Blizzard Rink, you and which you share in company. A reminder, I'll be with you again on Thursday night when the Ponies will take on White Bear Lake. The Clouds out the Suburban East Camford schedule and our home schedule. And then, of course, Holy Family on Saturday afternoon at 3 o'clock, 2:45 of broadcast time here in Club 1220. And online at tjsportsonline.net for the audio and video stream. So keep that in mind, tjsportsonline.net. That's the website for my company, TJ Broadcast Services. My clients include Stillwater, Cretin Derham Hall, Hill Murray, Augsburg, St. Kate's, and the University of Minnesota. That's right, I've got Gopher Baseball coming up on Friday, the 24th of February at USB. A little crossover between the MIAC hockey playoffs, basketball playoffs, and hockey in high school hockey playoffs. Going to be busy a few weeks here. So 9-1, just quickly recapping the first period, which saw 7. TJ Sagasore, the hat trick. Michael Kaufman had a goal. Austin Murr had a goal. Matthew Stanton had a goal. And Jesse Bukestad had a goal. In the second period at 12:04, Noah Cates getting his first goal of the hockey game from TJ Sagasore. TJ now with 3 goals and 2 assists, if I can read my scribbling. And then the 9-0 goal coming at 16:04. Jesse Bukestad is second of the game from Noah Cates and Austin Murr. Noah Cates now with 1 goal and 4 assists. Manning with 4 assists. And let's see, any other multiple scoring? I think that's it. Matthew Stanton has a goal and 1 assist. And Michael Kaufman has a goal and an assist. TJ Sagasore, 3 goals and 1 assist. I think I've got you all covered, okay. Well, Jesse Bukestad, 2 goals and 1 assist. Anyway, it's a 9-1 hockey game as we'll be playing running time in the third period. 8-0 was the final of the Chain V game. The Pony Chain V, Paul Vance's crew ran the record at 22-1 of the season. Outshot the Raiders 25-13. Luke Munson had the hat trick. Matthew McGinley had 2. And let's see, who else had 2? Jack Reinseth had 2. And I think we'll see Matthew McGinley. And we'll see Jack Reinseth. We might even see Lucas Munson here in the third period as well. I mentioned Hill Murray won their first game in the Section 4 AA semifinals. Mondsview and White Bear Lake were 2-2. That was a second period score. As we turn our attention to the girls' section playoffs in Section 1. And it was Linkville South beating Dodge County 4-2 in 4 overtimes, or 3-2 in 4 overtimes. The opponent girls saw Dodge County earlier in the season. That's a good club. And Farmington beat Lakeville North 2-1. So tomorrow night, Thursday night, the finals will be at the Owatonna Four Seasons Arena in a Section 2. The semifinals going on tonight, Eden Prairie and Chaska Chanhassen, Shakopee and Minnetaka. And the final at Ritter Arena on Friday, Section 3. And the final tomorrow night at 7 o'clock, Apple Bounty and Eastridge. Section 4 finals at Aldrich on Friday night, Hill Murray against either Moundsview or White Bear Lake. Section 5 semifinals tonight at Roseville, Blaine and Rogers, Maple Grove and Centennial. Final at Roseville on Friday night, Section 6 at Parade Ice Garden. And tomorrow night, Edina and Wayzata, Hopkins Park and Cretin Derham Hall. Section 7 semifinals, actually the championship game Thursday night at Fogarty Arena. Forest Lake will take on Elk River. And a Section 8, not sure who is, I think Brainerd is the top seed in Section 8 in girls hockey. By the way, the state high school tournament's getting underway tomorrow up at Bowavik. Best of luck to the Stillwater boys and girls ski team. They are at state. They won their sections in both the Alpine and the Nordic skiing. So they are at state up at Bowavik. And that begins tomorrow. I think the Alpine is tomorrow. And then the Nordic skiing will be on Thursday. So best of luck. We are between periods. I mentioned it is 9-1. And I want to get your opinion. We take a look at the possible 1 and 2 seeds in a boys hockey Section 1. Ponies saw Lakeville North here a couple of weeks ago, and they dominated the Ponies, winning a 1-goal hockey game. But they're the number one seed in Section 1. Double A. Lakefield South will be number two. In section two, Holy Family at Eden Prairie. What do you think, Russ?
Boy, I don't know. I don't know anything about their program except what Robbie Stauber told me a couple of years ago. They're a new program out there. It's a new school.
Holy Family?
Yeah.
Yep.
And
out there in Victoria.
A Catholic school,
yep.
And a private school, and they've really come along big, and they picked up some blue chip hockey players. Jackson Stauber was playing out there last year. He left this year to go play junior hockey somewhere where Robbie's trying to get his son in the best possible hockey at all, but they got a pretty good little program out there.
Yeah, they won 12 in a row. Eden Prairie has won 11, including that win against the Ponies on Hockey Day.
You know, Holy Angels had that for a while here a few years back, and they had a pretty good little program. Some of those private schools pick up some good players, you know, and it can change the whole complexion of their program. And we'll see. Stillwater's going to see them, what, this weekend?
Yep, Friday or Saturday afternoon at 3.
That'll be fun.
Section 3AA and Tommy Benelli's crew, St. Thomas Academy, they've won 7 in a row. And they'll be the number one seed in Section 3AA. Burnsville will be number two.
Well, Ron Vanelli told me, I talked to him this weekend, his brother Tommy and Greg, they co-coach it, Greg and Tom Vanelli, and they're great guys, and they've been around a lot of hockey, you know, and they got the academy playing at peak right now when they need to at this time of the year. Everybody's hurt. They had some injuries in the first part of the season, and they got everybody back, and everybody's pretty healthy right now, and they're playing good hockey. Like I say, they beat this Derham Hall Cretin team a couple of weeks ago 5-1, and they beat Hill Murray 5-1 last weekend, so they're at the top of their game. Look out for the academy.
Section 4AA, Stillwater 19-3, Hill Murray with that loss 15-4-4. Top two seeds, Whitefield Lake laying in the weeds, they're 13-6, and we'll see them on Thursday night. What do you think, Bobby Frado and everybody else for White Bear Lake? We'll see them Thursday.
Well, I don't think it's going to be the same kind of game we saw. Yeah. I mean, it was packed in that arena when they played at White Bear. And I mean, you know, the momentum was really going for the Bears at that time.
Yeah.
And I thought Isley let in a couple of soft goals he probably could have had. And then the other end, Bob Perano stood on his head.
Yep.
And when he run against a hot goaltender, yeah, especially at this time of the year, that means everything. I don't think Perano's going to be able to come in this building and play here with this Stillwater fan base and everything, and they're great. But the way the Ponies are playing tonight, they're going to try to crack him early. And if they do, it could be another high-score game for the Ponies.
Section 5AA, Centennial and Maple Grove. Section 6, Edina and Cretin Derham Hall. Section 7, everybody is talking about Elk River Zimmerman.
Well,
are they for real?
Timmy Matson, the coach of the Wilderness, went and watched Elk River play East, and they beat East quite handily 4-1,
really,
is what he thought. And this should be the year for the Elks to get to the state tournament.
Yeah, they won the football title.
Well, and they got some athletes there, and that's what it's all about. And Ben Gustafson, in his first year of coaching at Elk River, is doing a heck of a job there. You know, he coached at Hamline University for a while. He's a former Elk River player. He knows the system, and he's got them playing at the top of their game. And Timmy Matson thought, you know, they should clearly win Section 7AA.
And Moorhead St. Michael Elmerville in Section 8AA.
But you can never count those Greyhounds out.
Mike Randolph will have them ready.
Yes, he will.
We are at the end of two periods, and 9-1 our score. We'll take our final intermission break. More from the Blizzard Rink after these reminders on Club 1220 KLBB and on BAC Channel 15.
Stillwater Boys Hockey is brought to you in part by Lakeview Hospital, Stillwater Medical Group, and the Boys Hockey Boosters and their business supporter, RBC Wealth Management.
Party tonight?
Yeah, there's gonna be lots of beer and vodka.
Yeah, I just paid Josh $20 for we were gonna get so high.
Oh, do you think Josh gave us some more alcohol? I want to get totally wasted.
Yeah, maybe, but my sister has a fake ID. Maybe she could get it for us.
I wish my brother was that cool. My brother only buys me cigarettes.
Well, we better get to class.
Well, see you at the party.
All right, cool.
Late game, and I thought we really sounded good in the Fair Lake game.
And we welcome you back, and it'll be Matty Herdell Bauman to our left, and Seth Isley will start the period to our right. It is 9-1. And the one Raider goal, and that was Michael Kramer, his seventh of the year, power play goal at 15:37 on the assist with Michael Murphy.
I don't even see Mike Magnuson on the bench over there. I didn't get to find out what exactly would happen to him, but they don't even have him suited up this third period.
No, it looked pretty serious. Puck against the right wing boards and out the center ice. Raiders coming left to right. Turned back by that neutral ice forecheck by the Ponies. And into the zone and standing with Murr. Murr down the slot. Austin fires. And Matty with the save. The rebound swept away. Coming back. The speedster Matt Gleason into the zone. Matt at the point. Drop pass. Far side shot. And it's wide. Just wide on a shot taken by Daniel Magnuson, the sophomore defenseman. He's a good looking prospect as well.
Yes,
for
he
Jimmy
is.
O'Neill and Charlie.
Well, he's big. Jimmy's big on his team for next year, too. I mean, really. They got some guys that are young guys that can fly, and that's what hockey's all about, speed. And when Coach D was interviewed before the game, he talked about Cretin Derham Hall, speed and aggressiveness. But the Ponies have clearly dominated tonight. They haven't been able to give the Raiders a chance to get much speed going.
And face all the way back down to the Raiders zone, up along the right wing board for Nicholas Castro. He's taking another play in the Pony forecheck. And a center ice, and the move is Gimberlin into the offensive zone, lost it. Joe Riley for the Ponies back behind his own net. Drop pass in the corner for Dotko. Dotko leans it for the forward and played away to the line and out to center ice. Lead path a little bit too far for Michael Kaufman, and the Ponies are going to get whistled down for icing the puck. Out of town scoreboard. Park Cottage drove 2-0 over North St. Paul. First period, Mondview and Target 1-1. Second period, third period, Andover 3 and Coon Rapids 2. And St. Thomas Academy leading Manil St. Margaret's 6-1. Osseo and Anoka 3-3, second period.
I thought Ken Pauley was supposed to have a better team than what they've done this year, too.
They were pretty good last year, but this year, not so much.
Yeah.
Play inside the Stillwater zone. There's a shot rifled wide by Tucker Cruz. And against the far side boards, Huber gets it out to center ice. Raider try to get outside. Aggressive forechecking into the zone. But Brody Swanson catches one of his teammates offside of the blue line. Austin Murray inside that offensive zone.
Well, I just think the Ponies, you know, here and there, and it's always great. Home ice advantage is great, you know. I don't know why they don't have the Stillwater band here tonight and everything else they add to that.
They've been here two or three times this year. Yeah, hopefully they'll be here against White Bear Lake. Let's get some atmosphere here at the arena.
Because White Bear Lake sure had the atmosphere going in their favor when they played them there earlier.
And from the point, the Ponies hold it in. Dump down into the near corner inside the Raiders zone. Comes free into the corner. And there is Luke Manning. Manning and TJ on the forecheck. And there's TJ. He's got a goal, or three goals, and an assist. No Laney from the point jumps in to hold the offensive zone. Down low, TJ in the slot. Backhand, Manning, save, rebound, and it's off into that far corner. Sagasaur plays it up the wall, sent away to center ice. Stannard will get to it first for the Ponies, back into his own zone. Again, we're playing running time, 13:40 moving. And the rolling clock, Bjungstad will tip it in to the Cretin Durham Hall zone. Manning or Stannard will get to it. TJ with a bad angle shot hits the side of the goal. Stannard out of that far corner. Matt has a goal and an assist. In the slot through the skates of Matting. Comes to the point for Joe Roddy. Raleigh with a shot, and it just trickled wide at the half wall. It's headed. Ponies controlling the offensive zone. Up top for Novellini. Joey Beck has it down the slot to the side of the goal. Put wide by TJ Sagasaur. Back behind that is Nick Arendt for the Raiders. And Nick's a senior, one of their eight. Puck against the near side boards inside the Raiders zone. Comes the line, not out. Noah Dowes does pop free to center. Stanton goes right by the far side on the clearing pass. Maddock takes his man out of the plate. Bontic puck walks into the pony zone. Fed on that wing, walking in. There's the center pass. Great job by Novellini. He would throw his body at that and block that shot.
One too many passes, though, by the Raiders. They'd have shot when they had it in front of the goaltender instead of passing it off.
4-on-2, Ponies, and a deflected pass up into the stands. Nope. It's off the glass of the near side boards and sent into the zone by Raleigh. Raiders to walk it out of the zone. Stood up and neutralizes Liam Ryan. Ryan is a junior defenseman. One of six that is being used by the Raiders. Right in front of the benches across the way. Stillwater retreats. Bukestead back into his own zone. Hit Dutko in the skates, and Jesse gets it back. He and Joe Raleigh, the defensive pair. Breakout pass for Coffin. Coffin into the zone. Dutko, Parker in on goal. Center pass, shot. Isley, and he missed. Adam Isley had the goaltender down, and he went high, and he missed it. Adam had a goal right there in his sights.
Well, that was a perfect play. It was a two-on-one opportunity for the Ponies again to capitalize and get another goal. They just missed the net.
And the Raiders have the breakout back to center ice. And there is young Matt Gleason, and he gets double teamed as he enters the offensive zone. Broken up by Brody Swanson. There's going to be a penalty against the Ponies and a tripping call. They brought down Matt Gleason. And the Raiders will go on the power play. Time of the school at about the 5 or the 4:30 mark of this third period.
Well, one thing you got to, you know, what stands out here, and with Scott Bukestead living out here and putting on shooting camps out here and all his shooting schools.
I know
schools.
He's got some summer camps.
Yeah, and he's, of course, he's Jesse's dad, and he was a heck of a hockey player.
Oh, yeah.
At the university. Well, Paul Osby's here, and Paul was the goalie on that team when the first line for the Gophers that year was Bukestead, Griffith, and Butsy Erickson, and what a line it was.
A minor penalty has been
Raiders have the power play, and now play is whistled down.
Yeah, we got another penalty. It looks like a slashing penalty called against somebody.
Yeah, somebody's telling me that here in the Stillwater area, there are 5 former Gopher and Badger players that live here in the St. Croix Valley. Of course, Matt Dillman played for my games at the University of Wisconsin.
Well, Jay Cates played, too, you know, at the Gophers years ago. And, you know, and it's in the blood, Tom, you know. If your dad was good, most likely you'd be pretty good. And I asked Scott, you think your kid's better than you? Well, he's a lot better than I was. Of course, Scott played at Irondale High School years ago and was a great hockey player over there, but they didn't have the program like Stillwater has.
And it is now 4-on-4 penalty against the Raiders, taking a 2-minute minor with Johnny Gleason. Talking about Wisconsin Badger hockey, and of course we lost a good one. Jeff Sauer here, not too.
Yeah, I'm so sorry to see that. Yeah, I had no idea he was that sick, and you know, I guess he didn't tell anybody. I don't know. And I go back with Jeff Sauer all the way back to Como Park, where he grew up in Victoria.
Oh, he went to Washington, didn't he?
Yes, he did. And his dad was the head coach of football and baseball and all that stuff over at Central High School for years in St. Paul. So Jeff was brought up a jock's jock all the time, you know. He was a great pitcher in baseball. I thought he was going to go baseball rather than hockey. But he ended up going, I believe, at Colorado College.
Yep.
And then he ended up coaching there.
And there's a shot on goal, and Seth Isley with a save.
No, that's not Isley in there anymore.
Is that Mitch Bailey in there?
Yeah, it's Mitch in there. They switched
goalies. Mitch Bailey, our senior goaltender. Yep, Seth came on. Mitch Bailey coming on.
Got it.
Our other senior goaltender. Mitch has his first save of the hockey game. 9 minutes to go here in this contest. Shot off the faceoff. That hits bodies out front. And there's a blast, and that again hits bodies. Joe Rodney to sweep it away. Rings it around the far side boards for Logan. Huber out to center ice, tipped up ice. And at his own blue line, it's broken up there by Nick Arendt. He'll send it into the Stillwater zone. And now the Ponies have a power play for about 35 seconds. Here comes Brody. Swanson up the near left wing. And Brody gets spun around. He leaves it for the defense. Joe Rodney back to Brody. And up the door, boards into the zone. Here comes Logan Huber. Logan fires, and it's wide. Rebound off the far side. And that's put wide. A shot taken by Michael Coffin. From the point, Bukestead, rink wide. For Mapstone, Jack with the shot blocked. Rebound, Swanson, Brody fires. That's blocked. And the rebound to the line. Matt's going to hold the zone. 6 seconds to go in the Pony power play. Buck free to line and out to center ice. Mapstone trying to drive it in. And he hit the forechecker, Nick Davidson in his pads. And from neutral ice, the Raiders with the puck as we have 8 minutes to go in this one.
And you know, we had run time here in the third period.
Yep.
So that's why this period's going so fast. The clock don't stop. Six goals or more in high school hockey in third period.
Bjergstad does a 180 back behind his own at Jesse, killing some time. Leaves it there for Jack in that far corner. Mapstone to the line. And tipped out to center ice by the Ponies. And let's see, that's Adam Isley out there, Parker Dutko. And let's see who's the third man on this line, Austin Murr. Haven't seen Mason Bartosz for a while. And the puck all the way back down the ice, but Coach Doman has the luxury of using about five or six forwards for that third line.
He's got a lot of luxuries here with this program, and a lot to come coming up here. But you know, with 15 seniors on your squad, you got to make it this year, you know, and you need them playing at the top of their game this time of the year, and they sure look like it.
And of course, they seed for the state tournament, so we don't know who we'd face in that first round if we get past White Bear Lake, if we get past Hill Murray.
Yeah, let's not count our chickens before they hatch, Tom.
Parker Dutko in the offensive zone. Drop pass to Logan Hubert, sets up in the corner. Logan pops it up high in the air, taken away by the Raiders, and it's loose in the slot. Swept away by Michael Kramer. He's got the Raider goal. Up the left wing boards. Ponies to break it up. Then back into the zone. That's an offside. They didn't call it.
Nope.
There's a shot. And Mitch may have gotten a piece of that. Buck against the near side boards. And clear to line it out to center. They go rink wide for Huber. And Logan will send it into the offensive zone. 9-1. Ponies with 33-16. Our shots on goal. A 2-1 advantage. And from center ice, Michael Kramer sends it into the zone. Wide of the goal. At the half wall, far side, Mapstone takes care of his man. Back behind his own net, Jack up the left of the left wing board, taken away. Comes into the slot, played down that wing. Out front, tip attempt, Bailey with a save. In the crease, bodies down, net off his pegs. And the puck is not in the net, and we got a whistle.
Another thing that allows all that crap going on in the crease after the whistle, the net's moving so easily nowadays.
Yeah.
I mean, you can almost blow at it, and the thing will move off its little pipe that it's holding. And these things just got little, the posts are about 3 inches tall and about an inch thick. They're iron, and they got a little point that goes down, a little tip, like a spike. That's the only thing that holds the net on to the ice, and you just touch it, and it moves automatically.
Not the days when we used to
No, you jumped to the side and said, come on, run me. And you jumped to the side and let the guy hit the post. He'd break his shoulder. That'll teach you to run the goalie.
Raiders back in their own zone. Here comes their freshman, Matt Gleason. Gleason goes up the left wing into the zone. Pony zone out front. Bailey the save, the rebound, and it's in.
Yeah, nice play by Cretin Derham Hall. Coming in an odd man rush. 3-on-2 situation. Got it to the open wing on the right. Kind of golfed at it. I think it was Gleason. Johnny, the little Gleason.
Yeah, no, that's Billy Hansa getting the goal.
Oh, okay. Well, Gleason sure was in on an assist to make that play, but they were right in front of Bailey before all three of them with the puck in possession of Cretin Derham Hall, and they just golfed at it and went in the net to make the score 9-2 now.
Well, Billy Hansa getting his second goal of the year, and we'll wait and see on the assist. Billy Hansa, junior defenseman.
A lot of good juniors on this Cretin Derham Hall game.
Derham Hall, number 2, Billy Hansa, with the assist to number 5, Matt Gleason, and number 15, John Gleason. Time of that.
And so Matt Gleason, who took the initial shot, and Bailey made the save, but the rebound was there for the offering, and Billy Hansa buried it. 9-2, 4-20. Rolling here in the third period, as the puck sent all the way back down the ice, and that'll be an icing call against Cretin Derham Hall.
Well, you know, I coached there back the goalies. Jimmy O'Neill asked me to come on and volunteer coach for a few years. If I'd have been coaching there now, that John Gleason's name would be Jackie Gleason, one of our all-time favorites, that way.
you're dating yourself.
Right. To have some fun with these kids, because there ain't much fun in that purple and gold bench tonight. I'll tell you, these Ponies are just putting it to them.
Off the faceoff, Coughlin, Wisely, Adam Slot, fires up over the net. Rebound taken away by the Raiders. Played off the glass to the line. Not out. And walking it out front. And going down as he tried to make a spin move was Brody Swanson. The Raiders back down ice. And it'll be an icing call against CDH. As we're down to the 3:30 mark in this one. Ponies about to win their 20th game of the year. Of course, last year they just lost that one game. Actually, the two games. during the regular season.
Well, you know,
one game during the regular season and the two games at state.
Getting to the state in the state, that's what counts.
Yep.
And they got to be awfully hungry this year here in Stillwater to take that state pennant home.
Yeah, 15 seniors. There's a shot and a save there by Manny. And the puck in front gets the far side boards. Set away to center ice. Back checking, broken up by Brody Swanson. Fanning on a pass was Kaufman. Back to Brody. And tipped into the offensive zone. Cleared again. Back out to neutral ice. And the Raiders on the wing far side for Edward Burtis. Burtis sends it into the pony zone. As Bailey plays it back behind that for Isley against the near side boards. And Adam gets it out to center ice. Adam, of course, the younger brother of Seth. Adam's a sophomore. Seth is a senior. Bouncing puck at center ice. Overskated by Isley. Adam gets it back into the zone. Drop pass. Kaufman. Michael fires. Glove save by Matty Hurdle Bauman, one of their eight seniors. And he'll drop it there for the defense. Breakout pass to center on the right wing for Jack English. And a centering pass broken up. All the way back down to the Raiders zone. Out to neutral on the intercept. Dutko into the zone down the left wing. Parker lowers that shoulder. Watch the goal line back behind the net. Dutko still in possession. Goes up top. Raleigh plays it down low in the corner for Logan Huber. He spun around on a check. And the puck free in the near corner of the Raiders zone. We hit the 2-minute mark. Pass through the slot. Nobody home for the points. Swept away by Tucker Cruz. Cruz plays to the line and out to center ice. Coming off the bench is Raleigh to fire it back in inside the Raiders zone. It's on goal. And Matty will cover up and hold on to get a whistle and a stoppage of play.
Well, there was a good another, again, rush by the Ponies to come on. Their shot was taken from the blue line. Manny came out and caught it and kept moving the puck. This time he elected to freeze it. What's the difference when you're down by 7 goals? But you want game management is so important to a goaltender. A lot of these kids don't understand it. They don't understand it in the junior leagues of game management.
Again, the Ponies will have a one-game lead with one game to go, so they won't secure the league title here tonight, but they will have a one-game edge with one game to go. They'll have to beat White for Lake, or Cretin Derham Hall could lose to Forest Lake, and that's not going to happen.
Forest Lake program down pretty much this year, huh?
Yep. 1 minute ago in the period, puck inside the Pony zone, walking down that left wing. There's a shot deflected by Bailey up over the net, off into the near corner. And puck up along the near side boards. It's sent all the way down the ice, and that'll be an icing call. Now, the Raiders will be out. Lick Shattering up in Forest Lake on Thursday night. The Ponies here home against White Bear Lake. And then non-conference to close the season, the Raiders will be hosting Holy Angels on Saturday afternoon at the Highland Arena. And the Ponies will be at Holy Family on Saturday afternoon at the Victoria Recreation Center.
Were you going out there to do that, Joe, Tom?
Yeah.
It'll be a fun one.
Take Highway 5 and the downtown Victoria. Take a left and head out toward Deer Run.
Well, the last time I was out there, it wasn't one kind of Polk and Plum towns I live in up there, like Willow River. You
Victoria.
Poke your head out the window, you're plumb through the town, Tom.
And there's the buzzer. Horn sounds, and this game is complete. 51 minutes have gone by, and the Ponies with a convincing 9-2 win here tonight. And again, their 14th win in conference and their 20th overall. And for Cretin Derham Hall, they are now 13-2 in conference at 16-7-1 overall. We'll be back and recap it after this 2-minute timeout. And this is Pony Hockey on Club 1220 KLBB and on BAC Channel 15. Back in 2 minutes.
5:30 Thank you for attending Hockey.
Stillwater Boys Hockey is brought to you in part by Lakeview Hospital Stillwater Medical Group and the Boys Hockey Boosters and their business supporter, RBC Wealth Management.
Tonight?
Yeah, there's gonna be lots of beer and vodka.
Yeah, I just paid Josh $20 for weed. We're gonna get so high.
Oh, do you think Josh gave some more alcohol? I want to get totally wasted.
Yeah, maybe, but my sister has a fake ID. Maybe she could get it for us.
I wish my brother was that cool. My brother only buys me cigarettes.
Well, we better get to class.
Well, see you at the party.
All right, cool.
You can't have a goalie collapse like that.
Well, a convincing win for the Ponies, and they did it in the first period with 7 goals. The hat trick for Jesse T.J. Sangasur. Michael Kaufman had the goal, the first goal of the hockey game, 58 seconds in. That kind of set the tone. And 3 minutes later, T.J. had the first of three in the period. Austin Murr had a goal. Matt Stannon had a goal. Jesse Bjungstedt had a pair of goals, including a power play goal. The Ponies had 3 power play goals, 1 shorthanded goal, so 4 special team goals out of their 9 tonight. Noah Cates had a goal. He also had 4 assists. Mentioned Jesse with the goal, his 11th on the year. And again, 36-19 with the shots and goal for Cretin Derham Hall. Second period goal and a power play goal for the Raiders. It was Michael Kramer getting his 7th of the year at the 15:37 mark with an assist from Michael Murphy. Third period goal at 11:50, and it was Billy Hanzik getting the goal with the Gleasons. Johnny and Maddie getting the assist on that goal to make the margin 9-2 here at the end. And so with the Pony sweep here tonight, the JV pins an 8-0 shutout on CDH. Jesse Braun got the shutout, and 2 goals from Lucas Munson. The hat trick for Lucas, 2 from Jack Reinseth, and 2 from Matthew McGinley, and 1 from Joey Pitty. So it's all Ponies here tonight at the rec center.
Well, these people got to be proud of their Ponies because they put on an awesome show, both JV and varsity, here tonight. And this is the way to play hockey. But this is the time of the year you need to play that way. I like to see Seth Isley get a shutout. You know, that always goes good for a goaltender. You know, it's tough to play in a hockey game like this when you only have, you know, 15, 19 shots in you.
Yep.
The whole game, 3 shots the first period. You don't really get loose at all. You really don't get in the game. And he's the guy that's going to have to come up big here as they're going down the road, which he's capable of doing. But we thought Magnuson was capable of doing tonight, and he kind of deflated, and then he got injured. I hope he's okay. But, you know, Cretin Derham Hall's got some work to do in order if they're going into this section the way they look tonight.
All right, we mentioned the Raiders at Forest Lake. The Ponies home to Whiteville Lake on Thursday night, 7:50 on broadcast time here on the network. A broadcast here tonight made possible by Stillwater Motors, Pro-Life Across America, First National Bank of River Falls, the Stillwater Family Dental Clinic, also brought to you by RBC Wealth Management, and Russell Bohanni's appearance made possible in part by Mr. Benelli.
Mr. Ron Vanelli at Vanelli's by the Lake, downtown Forest Lake, right on Main Street, right on the lake, a beautiful place to dine. You know, they got crab, all call the crab meat you can eat every Wednesday night.
How about that
prime rib specials Friday and Saturday, Tom? The place is packed. You got to call for reservations to get on in, but thanks to Ronnie Vanelli and Vanelli's by the Lake.
Well, to run the rest of the credits, Jordan Simpkins, our director here tonight. Frosty was on camera. Patrick Frost, Angie Markworth back in studio pushing the buttons. And thanks to all of you for watching and listening to Pony Hockey here tonight. 9-2 is your final from the St. Croix Valley Rec Center in Stillwater. I'm Tom Wichin for Russ Bohanni. Thank you, buddy. Good night, everybody.